would like to go first. So this is the player that's always online while I'm streaming. So usually he plays the thing that we just said's a bad matchup for us. He plays like Sapphire Ruby stuff. We'll keep this. Play this, get a Sapphire and one here so we can focus next turn. He's been playing Mono Ruby Valor. Okay. Probably worth transmogging. It's gonna generate him value. Yeah, let's just take him off of this. Not quite sure what he's doing just yet. And this sacrifices to give him a charge. Sure, yep. Get a valor. So I think I'm just going to play Lapidary out here. Seems fine. He's like obligated to kill this right away. Now come in here and hang out with Dad. Oh, you wanted the blanket. Okay, go ahead. Yep. So I really don't mind him going super wide here since we have Clash in our hand. So, I mean, we've got plenty of life, 25 starting, so go ahead and extend out as much as you want. Infinite Tricks is not bad. That's a little unfortunate. I think we're going to take the other Lapidary here. And play this Forbidden Tomb Seeker out, pass the turn. That is the control magic guy. So when this has flight on attack with the Diamond Gem and when it deals damage to our opponent, we have to take one of their troops away. So we're gonna take a hit for three here. He's probably, if he has his best line here is Heart of Embers, he can go Heart of Embers, play a Valor, kill my Tomb Seeker. Gain a charge, sure. Well, that's pretty good for us. No idea what he's doing. Well, of purpose. Okay, let's play this out. Get a second Sapphire. It really doesn't matter. We only need two Diamond and a single Sapphire in this deck since we're not playing the Empress of Ice that we talked about. Yeah, I think I'm just going to go ahead and hit with the Tomb Seeker here. I'm just going to jam the Infinite Tricks here. Next turn I can even shift off onto here and then play this Lapidary to reset the tricks. Yep, so this is getting 2-for-1, which is fine. This is actually, I should probably just be using this, because he's going to get to Valor up his dorks now. Huh. I guess I didn't think about that. He's probably going to Valor both of them, spread it out. No? Okay. Okay, down to 16 here. I really wish he'd play something else out so I could clash him. Alright, let's play this. I think I'm just going to bring this dork to justice before he throws a Valor on it. Do I know his last two cards are Valors? I feel like I probably do. This card seems reasonably powerful. Just like, it's this 2-drop. It's like, you need to kill this, or it's just going to like grow completely out of control. And like when this gets big enough, we can shift off its draw ability. There's Heart of Embers. That's a good draw. Which kills this. So we're looking for a transmog or a martyr here so we can clash and then take out his other guy. All right, ask and you shall receive. Do this, keeps that. Do this. All right, your move. So if he finds another heart, we could be in trouble. Otherwise, we're going to be in a pretty good spot here. That's fine. I think we're going to champ power this. Four is a lot. Probably not going to have a much better spot to use this. Fireball my dark. Sure. Kind of wish I would have waited on this now, because if he would have done that, I would have just martyred this. Alright, well, he's got nothing. Silver Talon would be a great draw. Well, I guess it's a medium draw. Focus. That's not bad. The question is, am I tunneling this? I think I am. There might be merit to just martyring this and then waiting on this guy. So Reese is a card that you used to see a lot of play, but doesn't see a ton of play anymore. He says, he tunnels for four, and then at the end of your turn, if at the end of your turn, he makes either a worker bot, or if he was tunneled, he makes a random robot. Let's take that out of there. Hopefully he just doesn't have a troop this turn. Sweet. Now Talon would be great. All right, I think I'm going to hold that for now. Might as well. Any of his troops are going to be lethal pretty quickly, so we need to fade a troop for a turn or two here, so that way Reese can untunnel. Oh, yeah, I forgot there's assault cards. That's super true. Alright, clash means we can get rid of these two Monuments of the Martyr if he does draw a troop. Which is nice. Sure. Yeah, I'm just going to clash now. I don't want to take damage. So he's going to keep that, and we'll avoid the Monuments of the Martyr. This takes the power. This doesn't have points of power now. This only does something when he plays an Ardent Troop. So he probably has a Valor in his hand, so he's going to Valor this, and then hit me and make another Valor, which is okay. One of the cards in his hand is a Wine right now. Next turn, we'll play Tricks and put probably Flight and Life Drain on this guy. Life Drain Steadfast? Yeah, Life Drain Steadfast is probably better. This is the part of the game where we just, like, take out our wallet and slap our opponent across the face with it. So, our dwarf untunnels, comes up out of the ground, it's like, hey, how about them random robots? Yeah, I think if this Reese connects, it makes a robot, like, we're super far ahead. One of his cards is a Valor, and one of his cards is a Wine, so we should be okay here. And he has speed, because when troops come off tunneling, they gain speed. Just casual 12-point life swing here. Make a random robot at end step. We get a recoiler. When this enters play, return another card you control to your hand. All right, well, we'll put it for the tricks back at our hand, I guess. This is actually a nerf Reese spot. This is, you know, this is not, generally not good for Reese. Ooh, he had a removal and he drew a removal. Okay, so we still have a game, as they say. So both, oh, he doesn't have a Wine. I was thinking this gives a Wine every turn. This doesn't. This only gives a Wine when you play an Ardent thing. Funky Dude with the Twitch Prime subscription. Thank you. I appreciate the support. Welcome. So, Lapidary is an interesting draw. So I think this is actually a choice now. So like infinite tricks here, I think I'm just going to play it and shift off, because when I play Lapidary, Trick says whenever you play another Necrotic, you get to revert this. So I can shift Flight off of this onto here and hit him for 4. And then next turn I play Lapidary, which will let me revert my infinite tricks back to a 3-4 with Flight, and he'll be dead in air. It's like, don't even need this landing pause site this game. Let's double check the cards he's playing here. That's fine, we'll take one. Get your Valor. I'm gonna play this Necrotic, which reverts my tricks, and then he's dead. Alright, so it seems like a great Repel Totem Trap matchup. The Bring to Justice seems real bad against the Valor deck. Pride's Fall seems fine. We really need to kill his Heart of Embers ASAP. So Martyr seems medium in general, but I think it's definitely necessary for that reason. This might be a trim some of the Lenu Pause site. Yeah, got into Hex watching this channel. Awesome, I'm glad you're enjoying it. Game is definitely a lot of fun. Loving the beard. The beard is mostly because I've been lazy, but the wife kind of likes it too, so we've been keeping it around. Plus toughness on the Lapidary. Ooh, that's a good idea. That's a great idea. I always forget I can change gems on things. It's funny, when I play big events with Crusaders, I actually put a sticky note on my monitor that says, change gems in Crusader, you idiot. I'm not sure Clash is great in this matchup. I feel like especially post-reserves, he's going to be a little bit more, or once he's seen, he's going to be a little bit more conscious of it. I don't think we want none, but I think 4 is probably too many. And maybe I'm supposed to trim another landing pause site here. Let's do this. I think Lapidary, especially with the plus toughness gem, is going to be great. Yes, we're cutting the Bring to Justice, 2 Clash, 2 Land of Pause, bringing in Repels, Traps, and Pride's Fall. This seems okay. I want some Clashes to clean up the Monuments of the Martyr I put on the board, but yeah. Hey, let's do this. I don't think this is a Soothing Breeze matchup, but I could be wrong. It seems fine. It's got focus on 1, repel on 2, infinite tricks is pretty good in the matchup. So when we were building it, I definitely don't want a fourth adjudicator in the main. I don't think its upside is worth enough to have the random downside to Hero Fall be worth it. But in the board, a lot of these aggressive decks, when you can't play adjudicator to gain life on 4, and you can't play adjudicator to draw cards on 4 against an aggressive deck either. So it's kind of awkward, and you really don't want it ASAP. You want it a little bit later. Doesn't have another shard. Okay. I mean, really, like, again, what matchup do I really want it? I don't think I'm supposed to martyr one of these dorks. The wines kind of get to a critical mass. I guess, okay, this is actually kind of funny. Okay, he must have an assault card. I was gonna say, if I martyr one, I can then repel the other when he attacks with it because it has a point of power. Yeah, I think I'd honestly rather just... I put two Soothing Breezes in the reserves. I think I'd rather just have Soothing Breeze in matches where I feel like I need to gain life. Has to discard. Yeah, that's fine. Drawing an Onchard at some point this game would be great. We technically didn't even draw the Repel. We focused into that. Now he has one wind. Yep, every time he plays a thing, he gets a wind. I'm just assuming all of his troops are Ardent. Alright, has double removal. Because Mentor of the Wind has to die to gain you life, Soothing Breeze gives you life right away. Oh, I have to... I'll toggle the decklist on right now. I always forget it makes them private by default, which is good. I want them to be private by default. I have to log in. And it's public. If we draw a Reese at this point, we're just playing it out as a 5-5 to make worker bots. Yeah, Clash is okay. Hopefully he goes a little bit wider here. He probably has a Last Guard's Vengeance in his hand. At the very least, he's been representing it by attacking with these. I think I'm willing to take one more hit here. I don't know. He might start just Valoring next turn, which is a little annoying. So maybe it's time to Clash plus Martyr. It also takes his wine production out of play. Just get a 2-for-1 off of this. If we don't hit, like, Reese, I'm just going to Clash. Gross, another shard. So, that'll kill two of these. I'll have a 3-1 left over. Each champion draws 2 cards. Deal. Then there's another wine that, like, makes, I'm just gonna martyr this, I think. Might as well get it out of there. Man, God bless him letting us draw 2 cards, otherwise we'd be super dead. I think I'd bring in Lasgars against us. We've got Lapidaries, we've got High Infinite Tricks, it cleans up Reese and the robots that he's created. I would not be surprised to see a Lasgars Vengeance out of him. So, I think I'm going to Tricks and shift Life Drain onto this. And I'm going to put Steadfast on it too. Actually, I'm just going to shift fully over to it. That gives him the ability to kill this, but it makes this much better. And honestly, we might just, like, leave this as a 5-7 and just, like, never, just, like, keep beating him down. Oh, he's double fireballing it in response. That's pretty good. Okay, I should have played around that, I guess. My idea was to get it out of double removal range, but I guess that punishes me for that. If he has another removal spell for the Tricks, he has a removal spell for Tricks. And this could definitely be like, so if we were playing Rutherford Banks this game, he just could not win the game, most likely. We'd be 2 points of life lower, so we'd be at 17 right now, but we would get to, like, Banks this Lapidary back into play. It would just be like a 4-6 that he could never beat. Yep. Infinite tricks down. Instead, we just have a champ power that's really not doing anything. I understand that this ability is good against, like, flying troops, but... I think he has at least one more wine in his hand. Hey, Zach. Afternoon. Fireball me, activate this. Oh, okay, sure. Ooh, this is real bad. This is really bad. I guess I've got my champion power here. Alright, stall hall number one. Play infinite tricks. Go ahead. He discarded to hand size. Oh, that's true. Yeah, I guess he discarded two's infidel. Okay. He probably, I don't think he has any wine then. Burn to the ground, sure. I just have no idea what he's doing. Hey, look at that. That's a pretty good adjudicator. Gain five, draw two. God bless America. Yeah, but he's got Valors in his hand, so if he's smart, he can play around Totem Trap. A link between the local Hex client and worker bot so it can message chat, for instance, whenever a game starts. Yeah, something like that would be sweet. Silver Talon is dead. That's a good one. I know we boarded two of those out, but it feels good to find one of the ones that's left in our... Ugh! Ugh! Oh, God. Oh, God, we're so dead. Things that feel miserable for 100. All right, well, we're probably boarding out the last site for this next game if we lose this. Which it's looking like we're about to lose this. I think at least two of his cards are Valors right now. Probably should have held that chart. I'm just going to Clash, and then hopefully he doesn't Valor this Emberleaf Invoker, and I can Totem Trap out. I think I'm going to bring in some Verdict of the Ancient Kings for our next game. He brought in a lot of removal. Okay, yeah, we're dead. Yeah, I'm going to bring in two verdicts, because just like playing like an infinite tricks out and protecting it, or a Reese out and protecting it, is pretty much game over. Got Josh with the Twitch Prime subscription. Thank you for that. I appreciate it. Welcome. New subs, make sure you check out the subs-only Discord that we have set up. It's really sweet. Yeah, I think I'm just keeping like this. Nero Genus with the 8-month resubscription, 2/3 of a year. Welcome back and thank you for the continued support. I'd like to go first. We will have less than half shards in the top half of our deck this time. You did have a notification, got Josh. I even said your name. Pikachu laughed and everything. That was actually my children. That clip is actually my children laughing. Hey, Sam Keck. There's a 3-1 Pride's Fall. Notably not great against that. Totem Trap, not a bad pickup. Another one, sure. So that makes another Valor for him, which is good because that means his hand's going to be loaded up here so we can draw some cards with the Silver Talon next turn. I think I'm just Totem Trapping here. Yeah, I'm just going to Totem Trap here. Preserve our life total. If that would put us low enough that we could gain life from this, I'd have just taken the hit and cycled this turn. But I think I'd much rather just get this going on here. Draw two. Looking like a little bit of a repeat of last game. It's unfortunate. Yep. There's a Phoenix in his deck? That's so strange. Okay, sure. Well, the fact that this is a 5-3 means I can Martyr the Phoenix and then Pride's Fall this, so that feels good. And I'm just going to go ahead and do this now because we know he has Riposte in his deck. So he has a Wine and a Valor in his hand right now. Wine and two Valors in his hand right now. It would be nice if we drew cards that did things. Them's the beat sometimes. I think we're just going to use our champion ability here. We're going up to six. I'm just going to go ahead and use this to gain three, basically. Up to 9, 10 shards, and 15 cards. This is Heart of Embers, sure. I'm pretty sure we're just on the zero outer at this point. We have to deal with this, and we have to deal with the rest of his board. We're playing 25. I don't know if I even want to play this deck again. Yeah, I'm just gonna join with the brunch deck because we're probably gonna play that same person again. I'm going to cut some of these totem traps because they're really awkward against decks that aren't McBombus. I mean, the deck my opponent's playing isn't a deck. Like, it's just we're likely to queue into the same person again because of how Hex queues. I think I'm going to change to Rutherford Banks and just see how that feels. Between tricks and lapidary and just everything, I want more grind. All right, let's get with this. The way to help any matchup is, you know, draw more than one third spells. Even if it would have been at like 50% shards to non-shards, I think we would have been okay in either of those games. The riposte really, really blew us out in the second game. We didn't have a lot of resources to work with, and we finally hit something. He had the answer for it. Sweet. Playing against something not him. We played against that same person we just played against like four times on stream. Was it Thursday or Tuesday? One of the days. I think this is a keep. This is like, this is a shard, but not really. Like, this is, we can cycle this later. Forbidden Tombseeker can get out of control and we get to play it on two. Blood Wild with Running Deer. Okay. I'm going to play the Shard of Purpose on one because I don't really know what we're looking for just yet. Tombseeker out. Simply Monk with the new Twitch Prime subscription. Thank you for the support. Welcome. This enters play. Create a random troop. Can't be blocked. Okay, that's an interesting combination. I think I've seen those two on the rabbit before. No, I just switched to Banks Champion because I want to generate value, I think. Tombseeker into Sight's pretty good combo. So this card gets bigger every time we draw a card. Am I supposed to offer this trade? I feel like I am. I feel like he's not going to take it. And if it does, I'm probably okay with that. Wow! Okay, sweet. Maybe the Lanupa Sight encouraged him to take that, but I think I'm okay with that. Maybe I'm secretly not. I don't know. Maybe I'm supposed to let this get huge so I can be threatened to Banks it back later. You'll need to refresh your Twitch chat in order to have the emotes appear for you. Infinite Tricks draw card. Yep, sign me up. Murder draw card. Still miss a shard, yep. I'm assuming this was the random. I guess that could not have been the random. Alright, play this, draw a card. We're very focused this game. Forbidden Tombseeker. Focus. And remember, focuses don't count as drawing cards, so they wouldn't make my Tombseeker bigger if I played it first. This counts as drawing a card, though. I think I'm going to attack with tricks here. So, I think I'm just going to focus this turn again, because I'm likely going to Martyr. And I might wait to pass. That's great. Maybe we want two shard prisms. I might wait to play this until after I Banks back my Forbidden Tombseeker, because if I Banks back Forbidden Tombseeker, I can shift all the powers off of Infinite Tricks and then play my second Forbidden Tombseeker and revert this. Extinction. Okay, I just have no idea what's going on over here. Crackling Vortex probably is probably doable. Yeah, actually, that's a really good idea. Yeah, so I'm just going to go ahead and martyr this dork, which also draws us a card. This deck only needs double diamond, single sapphire. So that's a very good suggestion, and we will take a look at that after this game. Silver, Talon, Adjudicator. So, oh geez, and he gained life last turn? This is perfect. So I can play this. I can play this, which is going to gain me life and draw me cards. That's wonderful. Attack with this. And then I'm going to use my last two resources to shift onto the bird. Steadfast and life drain. If I play Tomb Seeker first, it gets plus... No, I want to use the Tomb Seeker to revert this. I think reverting this is more powerful than making the Tomb Seeker 2 larger. I could be incorrect on that, but I think that's what my gut says. We're kind of exposed to a croc here. Extinction, sure. Also plays around Extinction, which I guess we saw out of his crypt when he flipped over with Cottontail. So I can play this shard out, which puts me to 7 cards. I could play this Tomb Seeker out. That's unfortunate. So what do I want to do here? I kind of want to wait on this. Yeah, I'm going to play this Tomb Seeker out. And I'm going to cycle this Shard Prism for now. And I'm going to wait until I can get the Silver Talon back with some extra text on it. Ooh, Lapidary is pretty good. I think I'm just going to pass here. Yeah, I'm just going to pass. Fentio. Okay. Card's kind of scary. Crackling Blob. Void 3 target troops in a crypt. Gain 1 life for each troop voided this way. That's actually a hate card against us, huh? I wonder if that's another random one he got. Why not get wild in case you Lapidary a Hyro and need the gem or blood? Yeah, that's true. I didn't think it mattered, but you're correct. Wild doesn't matter. I guess, yeah, wild doesn't matter because it wouldn't come into play under our control, but... So I think we're just going Martyr Transmog here. These are both threes, right? Yeah, let's start with Transmog. Ooh, Martyr should have gotten it. It's more resource efficient to Martyr. He has a Visage of the Masquerade. That's fine. Alright, let's play this. And then I can Martyr this. And then, man, I still can't get extra text on that just yet, huh? Well, let's play Lapidary and pass the turn. Can't attack with this just yet, because I gave him a 4/4. It's possible I'm supposed to flick the tricks back into play with this, but I kind of like holding the Rutherford Banks activation as extinction insurance. Yeah, no blocks. This could be an extinction turn, so. He's through 2, so probably as the third. VK, okay. Has a shard. Shard's a little awkward because it means we can't, again, draw cards with Silver Talon just yet. Like I said, it's very possible I should have put the tricks into play last turn. I guess now I should have put... Yeah, I just clicking too quickly. I should have put the... Because I drew another one of these. Well, that's awkward. All right, so what we're looking for Clash of Steel now, I guess. Have we played a Clash in 20 cards? We've not played a Clash in 20 cards, so. All right, one in whatever chance. Wow, that's aggressive. No blocks. Yeah, no blocks. Because now if we hit Bring to Justice something for this Mistress ability to take two of his guys, that's super aggressive. All right, come on, removal spell or Clash? Perfect. All right, so martyr this idiot. Play this. All right, and then hit you with these two lapidaries that fly. I would like to activate. I guess we're taking the VK, right? It's probably the VK and the Fentio. Yeah, it seems right. Banks back the Silver Talon Adjudicator. Draw two, gain five. This will get two larger. We got a Reese and a Bring to Justice. I think we're bringing the Rabbit to Justice here, and then I'm going to tunnel this as insurance. That seems fine. This might be a little greedy. I might supposed to just play this out for a worker bot. He could have another extinction though. And like if he has another big play, we're gonna need this to try and go over the top of it. And hopefully we just hit a clash here at some point. We're 20. There's three tarantula eggs in our deck right now, so there's 34 cards in our deck and four clashes. Tunnel Reese would be, yeah, exactly. Another VK, sure. That VK is very large. When do I want to shift the power off the Tomb Seeker? Yeah, I probably should have put that on the Vampire King last turn. Yeah. Yeah, I probably should have moved this. Yeah, Marshall Josephina is good at, like, when you're pressuring your opponent, but, like, when you need to get back into a game, something like Rutherford Banks is what you want. That must be one of his randoms. All right. It's a giant caterpillar. That's a 4/4. All right. Well, let's see how he attacks here. He might just attack with this. Okay. Yep. This is basic to shift, right? Yeah. Yeah. I should have put this on Vampire King last turn. Silver Talon Adjudicator. Sure. Let's activate this. Am I just playing this to gain life? I feel like I am. I feel like the odds of him having cards in his hand for the rest of this game are pretty low. Does putting this into play make combat better for me? Yeah, I think it does, because I can use these two to trade for his Vampire King. Then my Vampire King can stay in play and continue growing larger. Skip. Yeah, exactly. I don't think he's gonna likely have... He might, like, mistakenly, like, hold a shard in his hand trying to bluff something, and we might get him that way, but I think outside of our opponent making a mistake, the Silver Talon's not drawing cards, and I'd much rather just commit it to the board so I can trade two Silver Talons for his Vampire King if he attacks. Since ours has the shift ability, when we draw cards, it gets bigger. We have Reese ticking away here. We've got Fentio loading his deck up with Tarantula Eggs. We've both got three Tarantula Eggs in our deck right now. And he correctly deduces that he should play the shard because we have Silver Talons in our deck. Sweet. Well, board stall. We've got a Reese and a Fentio going, so... And we've got Vampire King slowly growing larger. So this definitely favors us. And even as the game goes long, like, if Reese comes into play and then he hits an Extinction, that could possibly be bad for us, but that means this Fentio is just going to, like, keep ticking up here, so that's pretty good for us. Eventually, there'll just be enough Tarantula Eggs in his deck that he won't be able to do anything. So this turns into... And then 3, and then it turns into a Giant Butterfly, which is just a 5-4, so it'll be an 8-7 with these. Vampire King should be big enough to tango with that by the time this turns into something we need to worry about. Takes 3 turns. Yeah, 3 Metamorphosis counters, Giant Butterfly. And we're only two shards away from being able to bank something back again, which is sweet. No, the spider egg places the next card into your hand, so it does not count as a draw. So I'm going to go ahead and do this. I think I'm going to hold this Infinite Tricks back. I think we're winning the game at this point, and we haven't seen any discard out of him, and I'd much rather just hold this in case he does see the Extinction to try and beat down the Reese. Underworld Crusader, okay. You do you, opponent. Hopefully we get, like, Murdertron and some other crazy robots off of this. Charge Colossus would be great. Eventually, some of us are going to start hitting Tarantula Eggs, so that'll be good for whoever that happens to. He's got way more eggs in his deck than we do. We've only got 3 in ours. Bring to Justice. Well, that has Skyguard Steadfast now, so not really doing anything there. I think I'm just going to void this. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and void this. So that way he can't draw cards off of it in the event he finds an Extinction. Or a Tarantula Egg or something like that. So yeah, I'm just going to do that. This makes a random robot every turn now. So again, the board stall parity continues to favor us. We're also up on clock, which is nice. Ooh, a Tarantula Egg. Kill your Giant Butterfly. Don't mind if I do. Hero Fall, the Fentio. Sure. There's probably more than enough eggs in your deck at this point. Oh no, all my other Fentios are gone. And this can start attacking now, because it's going to be a 7-8 once we draw for the turn. Ooh, Lino Pause Sight. Don't mind if I does. So I'm going to go ahead and attack for 7 Life Drain in the sky. I wonder what his out is here. I can't imagine he has them. It's like hitting all 3 Tarantula Eggs in a row, and then we never hit any of ours, and we have a lot more of them in his deck. He is holding a shard in his hand, alright. Augmentation Bot. Another target robot you control gets a random keyword. Crusader, sure. We probably lose, Ace. We probably lose. Actually, it's different, right? Because he has the Mistress of the Bones. I'd attack with both Lapidaries, and, like, I'd exile the Vampire King, attack with both Lapidaries, and take his Fentio. So he's attacking with his VK. Continue to clear our defense. Double block here. Pretty easy double block. Here, I'll trade off. Gain a bunch of life. Board stall continues to favor us. Another Infinite Tricks. This one draws a card. Let's attack with this VK and see what he does. He might jump here trying to find his Extinction. Yep. Hey, look, a Tarantula Egg. Kill this Exarch. And again, not playing these out because his line to win this game involves Extinction. This creates 2 replicas of that and puts it into my deck? Sure. He's dead on board. No, he's not. I'm still, yeah, I was going to say, he's got a lot of life. And this had... Maybe you were missing that this had Skyguard. He might be dead on board now. Especially with these tricks. Oh, the tricks kill him, and he's not dead on board. Rotten Rancor, sure. Man, These Visage of the Masquerade, they're doing work for him. Alright, Mime Bot's gonna give Overtime Bot, or Augmentation Bot's gonna give Overtime. The Augmentation Bot's gonna give the Overtime Bot some extra OT here. I think I'm gonna play this and put Flight onto here now. Crocosaur. Well, that's kind of terrifying. Well, that's how I could lose this game. Visage going super wide. Wow, he's trading that. That's kind of surprising. I guess that lets him attack this turn. I mean, like, yeah, I can respect this. This is his line to win. Ooh, it has Spell Shield. All right, continue to defense. So we're going to block here, and we're going to chump here, and then take casual 30 down to 13. Yeah, I think that's the line. It's bugged, how? All right, so we play this tricks and draw a card. And then we shift Steadfast onto here. Sometimes it gives nothing. Okay, we'll survive, I think. Shift Flight onto here. Shift Life Drain onto here. And then we'll play this other Infinite Tricks out and reset this one. And then we'll shift Steadfast onto here. I'm going to play this Well of Purpose. It's going to casually attack him for a bunch here again. Draw a Clash of Steel, sure. Alright. Hopefully we hit some Tarantula Eggs in these three draws here. That's unfortunate. He could... Oh, geez, we could die to these Visages, right? Like, he hits, like, two more 5-plus cards. We could die to these. Can we attack with the bots here as well? Yeah, I guess I could have. No, I want these as chump blockers, I think. Extinction. Yep. Okay. And then we've got a Banks Power coming up, so, yep. And then the real question is, what do I even want to Banks back? Let's do this first. This draws a card. Okay, we gave him a Tarantula Egg. Okay, we hit high Infinite Tricks, so... I think I'm actually going to put the Reese back into play. Do I want to clash here? I almost feel like I do. Nah, he might play. Yeah, I'm just gonna clash. Get rid of the three monuments. If he has removal, if he just has like removal right now, the VK is pretty bad. I think the Reese insulates us better. Go ahead and pass the turn here. Scrapyard Megatron. So that was his third extinction, right? Yeah, I think so. What a crazy game. This game's been really good. Yeah, but this is better if he draws removal on his next turn. If he has removal in hand, it really doesn't matter what we get back, unless it's like, we could have gotten Silver Talon back, I guess, to play around that. But like, Reese allows us to put value onto here. Shift just Reese to make sure you survive Croc. Ooh, that was a good point. Yeah, I definitely should have done that. Bud, Dad's working right now. Ugh! Can you say hi, toddler? Say hi, my name is Jacob. Alright, Steadfast. Yeah, hi! Hi, Internet! Shift all of these off. Get some flight going on here. Casual attack for 14 point swing. Don't have drawn hero fall. All right, give me another random robot. All right, we got a shield bot. Hollowed Ace with the 5-month resub. Welcome back. Yeah, the deck list should update every time I hit save, so... The old Petrobot. He has a fourth extinction in his deck. But watch, there it is. So when this dies, create a scrapyard bruiser. So that's lethal, right? So yeah, just that's fine. So this is my 2/2. And so he should still be dead here. Sans another removal spell. Because I can martyr that. Two tarantula eggs. Ooh, baby. Kill the rabbit dead. Die, bunny, die. Thank you for the Ventio. I appreciate the loan. Martyr doesn't kill him if he has a removal spell, so I think I was fine being a little conservative there. Dingler seems great. Bring to Justice seems great. He's got a lot of he's got must answer cards, but he's got a lot of expensive things too. So Transmogrified seems kind of medium. I'm not actually sure what I want to cut here. Clash seems great. I think I want the Brings and the Dingler. Open to suggestions on what to cut. Perhaps trimming one Lapidary and one Infinite Tricks is fine to be playing around Hero Fall. I think I like that logic. Just like play around Hero Fall a little bit. Like both these cards are powerful, but Hero Fall taking them out of our hand is not worth the risk, I don't think. And maybe I can trim one Transmogrificate if I'm bringing in the extra Bring to Justice. Pride's Fall. Ooh, yeah. Okay, yeah. Let's just do that and cut the Transmogrificates. So you're like actually killing his things. This is good against. This is good against his. What's it called though? Crusader, I guess. Eh, this is probably fine. Let's do this. Same seems fine. I'm going to need to play a little bit quickly. We're up on clock, but this game is going long. Or this match seems to be going long. Bad Strat MTG with the Twitch Prime subscription. Thank you for the support. I do appreciate it. Welcome. Exarch of the Egg. Yeah, I don't really care about that one. I'm assuming this is just still in his deck because he has a minimum underworld count he has to meet. Do I play the Lapidary here or the Lanupaz site? I think I play the Lanupaz site. I'm going to play the Lanupaz site. He probably would just kill this on the spot, and I want to make sure I get my velocity going a little bit here. I guess if I would have played this, it would have, that was definitely as random. It would have pressured him into not being able to add to his board. Banning to the board's not the worst, I guess, here. Am I playing Lapidary out now? Yeah. Silvertown's a little awkward, like I mentioned earlier. I think I'm just going to play Lap here. Can steal his Runeir Hierophant. So again, this card needs flight when it attacks. When it hits our opponent, we can void it to take control of one of their troops. And if he plays, like, VK here to block this, we can just, like, bring to justice the VK, crack him with the Lapidary, take the Runeir. I don't think I want to clash there. It's just like, it gets rid of these three things, and I really don't care about any of those things. I should get blood for when I take this. Huh. So how do I want to clash here? I think I just want to clash now, and then whatever he keeps, I take. He might keep the book, but then I get to keep this and take something with it later. Keep this one. So this is the start of each champion's turn. If the champion has 20 or more cards in their crypt, this deals damage to them. Yeah, he kept the book. All right, I mean, this is going to take something from him at some point, so that's fine. For now, we'll just beat him down with it. He's going to have to spend a removal spell on it. And he can pay 3, search opponent champions, and bury and put them into the crypt. Oh, he can take some of my prophesied cards with this, I guess, but I already drew off of... Could have rock cast. Yeah, he could have rock cast, I suppose. Yeah, Clash plus Lapidary is pretty good. We haven't drawn our action that's prophesized yet, I suppose. This is going to be really hard to draw cards off of because we draw a card when we play it, too. Took our Dingler and our Clashes. Okay, it's a good thing we have this other Clash in our hand. Which he probably knows about since he saw all the cards in our deck. Am I just playing this? I feel like I'm just playing this. I'm gonna attack for 2 and see what happens. He might think I have Ascension, that's fair. Yeah, I'm just gonna play this out. It's only gonna draw us 1 card and gain us a life, but it gets us to our next thing here. Another Trix, that's pretty good. That makes me wish I would have played out the first Trix, so we'll play another Landing Pause Site. I mean, now we got 5 power in play, so let's just keep hitting him. And it all flies. Extinction, sure. That's good. That makes me feel good about playing out this Infinite Trix next turn. Martyr. That's brutal. At least we have 3 draws in the bank here. Play this. Pretend we have Empress in our deck still. Reese. That sounds great. Am I just tunneling this? Do you think I'm just tunneling this? Am I supposed to put one of those back into play? No, I think I'm supposed to save this champ power for in case he kills the Reese. I doubt he has void removal. So he kills Reese plus Rutherford Banks is just very, very dirty. And just, like, if they don't have Void or, like, Diamond-based removal, like Martyr or something like that, you're just like, alright, put my Reese back into play, keep making robots, next. That seems fine. Just gonna martyr this. Attack for two. I mean, there's only two Reeses in this deck. I doubt even if a dozen people pick this deck up, I don't think it would drive the price of Reese that much. If you're Hero Fall, the Tomb Seeker, would I martyr it in response? No, probably not. I think I'd rather save my removal for his threats. Fenteo, sure. Probably have to bring that dork to justice. Especially because I guess it blocks my Tomb Seeker and my Reese, so it takes my pressure off the table too. Yeah. Just do this. Void that. Crack you for 8. Play a shard. Make a random bot. We're getting close to two Banks activations here, so you know he's gonna have to deal with this a few times. This is a robot. That's funny. Probably worth waiting to bring to justice rather than using Martyr, since we still have Martyr to deal with Croc. I guess that's fair. Yeah, he did show us Croc last game, didn't he? No, it drew when something untunnels, it counts as playing it. We don't get to draw a card from the Reese when we Banks it back, because it's just coming into play. We're not playing it, but all right. Robots, please. Mecha, mecha, hive, mecha, hive, mecha. Mecha, mecha, hive, mecha, hive. Bum, 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 bum. Ooh, I found a piece of candy. Ooh, I found a piece of candy. So mecha hive, you can pay one to make a bumblebot, and then whenever you gain a charge, it gets +1/+1. Let's do that. Make another Bumblebot. Play this Silver Town Adjudicator. Draw two cards. Maybe this is playing into an extinction too much, but ooh, Martyr's pretty good. So attack with everything. Is this lethal? So this is 8. If I martyr the Silver Talon, it's exactly lethal, right? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 11, 12, 13. All right, yep, YOLO. I totally did that math before I played out the Silver Talon. Big Kitty Fan with the 4-month resub, a third of the year. Welcome back. Thank you for the continued support. I do appreciate it. Doing laps. Speed 898 with the 4-month resub, a third of a year as well. Welcome back. Thank you for the continued support. It's just so powerful, Ace. And I know that you want synergy with the Lapidary, but I think the Lapidary is powerful enough on its own. Oh, crap. Crackling Vortex. Someone remind me. I just saw the messages this queued. Someone remind me that we want Crackling Vortexes after this match. Yeah, I definitely think probably two. Yeah, Saints keepable. Opponent's playing Uzu, so could literally be anything, likely Elixir deck. As we're getting towards the end of this match, someone say, hey, put some Crackling Vortexes in your deck. We could probably even play two of these Cryptus, to be honest. Just to, like, cut shards, but still keep the same number of thresholds. Or cut regular. Look at so many choices. So many choices. You're like, yeah, any of these could be Crackling Vortex and we'd still be okay. We only need two Diamond and a single Sapphire in this deck, so not intensive at all. So this prevents all damage that will be dealt to this by cards that you share a threshold with. So eventually, my opponent is playing a Lexel deck, and eventually they're going to have every threshold. Probably playing Lightning Plus Light next turn. We really don't care about Lexel in our deck because we have all Void, and Transform Removal and Transmog, so the upside our opponent gets for playing these cards is fairly minute against us. Clash, not bad. Okay. Could have main deck Verdict. It's not an unreasonable card. I will take my draws, though. So I'll make another threshold, and then I'll play Elixir and get his fifth threshold. Oh. Ooh, does this have speed? That's a beating. That's really good. Alright. I think I'm just getting rid of this. I don't want to take another hit from it. His deck definitely has Midnight Paladins in it, I can assume, so I don't really want to use my life total as too much of a resource until we have a way to life gain consistently. I think I'd rather have the utility shards, Ace. So I'm going to transmog his Eye of Lixil in response here because it stops him from drawing cards and just turns this into a 3-2 flyer. That's actually decent for him, which is unfortunate, but is what it is. Yeah, I pay attention to the list of mortals. These have been floating around for a little bit now. I'm assuming we're gonna get hit for three here. This is probably dead on a scale of 1 to dead. Lixil, sure. We're gonna like rockcast it or something? Gemborn Prowler in the main. Okay, it's rough. Clash plus Martyr, and I'm just going to play this. Probably taking 6 here down to 7, which does get us into a little bit of a scary range against his Midnight Paladins. Yeah, I definitely agree. All of my Underworld builds, like, Chrissy's been playing Kaiguru Crusader, and I always put an Underworld, what's it called in the main? Subtle Striker, sure, come on, play the Gemborn Prowler. Rats. Alright, well, let's play Clash. And we'll bring to justice whatever he keeps. I'll pick this one. Probably one of these two. I could see him keeping that realistically, though, too. Yep. Let's bring that to justice. That's pretty good. Attack for 3. So next turn, this will be a 4-4, and then we can shift Life Drain onto it. Probably Flight 2, honestly. Yeah, so he's got a Gemborn Prowler and one card we don't know. And even if it's a removal spell, if it's not Void... Oh, sweet. So he should be fairly dead here. I'm assuming he's going to play the Gemborn Prowler out too, because he has to race this. Alright, he hasn't played Gemborn Prowler yet. Yep, sweet. So we play Infinite Tricks, we shift all three things onto here, and we just, like, go to take him to Brown Town. He has to hit Void Removal to do anything, and we drew another Necrotic. Alright, excellent. I think we were winning this, even with just this one Tricks, but with two, we should definitely be a strong favorite. Especially since we have Rutherford Banks to insulate from an Extinction. The old Necrotic Mirror Match. Casual 14-point life swing here. Even if he draws a Tricks of his own, we've got a Martyr to answer this Lixil. No, he doesn't. He has Flight, Coach. It only gains the socketed abilities of the card that you void. It doesn't gain all of the text of the card that you void. So, Bring to Justice is great. Dingler's fine. I think that's all I want. Transmogrified, excellent. I think I'm trimming one ofs to play around Hero, or trimming four ofs to play around Hero Fall again. That seems fine. And then I'm actually going to cut a shard in the draw here. Yeah, let's do that. Tombseeker's been impressive. I like the Tombseeker resplit because it gives us insulation against Hero Fall. You need, like, random cards like that. We might even want just, like, one extra... Actually, you know what's probably good in the reserve for this deck? A Charge Colossus sounds insane. Like, Charge Colossus Rutherford Banks is just, like, a beating like people haven't seen in a long time. Tunnel Resun 2. Can't lose. By that, I mean we can lose, but we're keeping... Yeah, I'm going to jam. So we're going to jam Crackling Vortexes in here, probably two to start, and then we're going to put a Charge Colossus in the reserves, I think. And then just, like, wish Kai Galichu good luck when we play. Diamond Dragon. Yeah, that seems sweet. So I want a second diamond at some point for this, but that's fine. Hopefully we have time before that becomes super relevant. Play this out. We have Martyrs to hold off Dorks that he could play out ahead of time. He mulled, will never draw off Owl Dower, right? A couple of verdicts to protect Reese in these types of matchups might also not be the worst thing in the world. Alright, all of the Lapidaries, so... Does not play around Hero Fall, but that's fine. I trimmed one for a reason. Alright. There's his owl. It gives us hope to play an owl of our own. Yep, free attack, no blocks. Oh, Huh, not sure what I want to do here. Maybe just play out another Lapidary. That seems fine. Let's do that. Hopefully misses a shard drop here, so our Silver Talon's more likely to draw. Alright. Let's see here. So if he has a Crusader, he can push some damage, but then our Lapidaries are going to get to take the Crusader. Probably just attack with Exarch here to make the Lapidaries worse. Yeah. He really can't commit anything else to the board, because the Lapidaries just take it away. Line up a site. Send me up. Gives us something to do with our resources this turn when we really didn't want to play any of our other cards. That feels okay. Would not be surprised to see him Extinction next turn after the Reese comes into play. Hopefully we can start hitting some shard drops so we can bring Reese right back. Yeah. Lap's a lot like Marshall Josephina in that he contorts the way your opponent is forced to play a game, which is sweet. Am I just shipping with the squad here? I feel like I'm getting Extinction, so I'm just going to attack with everything and just push some damage through. Transmog. All right, well, now I no longer feel like I'm getting Extinctioned. Transmog's a pretty good answer to that. Hex Engine. Okay. Okay, what can I do with that? Am I just going to bring this dork to justice? I could bring this to justice and then hit with both of these. That seems fine. Winning the race now. We're just going to decline both of these abilities. Don't really care about this Exarch of the Egg. This draws a card when we play it. Yep. Just pressure our opponent while they can't really afford to play anything else out. Ooh, Spider Egg. Alright, play Shard. Draw. As much as I would like to just start doing something, I feel like I want to make him answer these two things before I commit anything else to the board. But this is just a 5-turn clock all on its own. It's like, yep, nope. No, I don't think I want to play Tombseeker. I think he's obligated to Extinction the board as is, and I just don't want to give him more value off of that. And Trix is another card that rewards me for having waited on the Tombseeker as well. Midnight Paladin, okay. Now I probably need to play the Infinite Tricks out. Yeah, I'm going to play the Tricks out now. And put Life Drain and Steadfast on this Lapidary. Actually, I'm going to split this up. So let's put Life Drain on this one. I'm going to put Steadfast on this one. I'm doing Life Drain first because that's the most important one. Yep, that's fine. That can transform. I still get my ability. I'll attack you for 5. Do I want to steal something? I don't think I do. I think I just want to keep... We're just winning the race still. Because especially since this is a 2-3 and can block this dork. Tricks of his own, sure. Am I doing this? That seems loose. That seems really loose. Yeah, I think I'm just letting this happen. And if he wants to shift all of them over to here, I'll martyr this, and then my Lapidary can hit it, and I can steal this, and then I can play this and revert it. This is fine, and now he'll attack with these two. Just that. All right, well, martyr. Attack with both of these. Oh, which Lapidary effect is this? I think this is this one. All right, let's hope I... Ah, damn it. God damn it. Okay, so I should hit accept first to take... I think I'm obligated to do this. That's frustrating. Oh, wait, what? Okay, well, that's what I wanted to do. Oh, no, I do not. Oh, if I hit cancel... Sweet, okay. So if I hit cancel, let's maybe it backs all the way up. That's sweet. Do I want to play this or this? I could play this. And when I play this, I draw a card. And it reverts this. And I'm going to hold this for a turn, I think. Although if I play this, then he can't attack in. Okay, yeah, I'm just going to play this because it'll revert this. Ooh, I found a piece of candy. Okay, do that. And then I'm going to actually shift off of this now. So that way, if he doesn't have extinction, he can't just kill this. Fentio, sure. Oh, I can Dingler next turn, right? Yeah, I can Dingler because I have Hex Engine. I forgot about that. Okay, my Lapidary is gone. See if his last card is Verdict. It's not. It's a Dingler of his own. Okay, well, that's awkward. All right. Well, YOLO. If he no blocks here, we'll martyr my Infinite Tricks and kill him. Blocked like smart person. All right, if he hits a shard, he hits a shard. GG's, Tramix. Alright, so let's make some changes. Collection. Oh, right, we're getting Dread Harvest now, randomly. Yeah, yay, Hallows Eve. Alright, so two Crackling Vortex and a Charge Colossus. Let's figure out what we're cutting. Alright, so I think I want another Dust in here, too. Just because, like, we really only need two diamonds. So I think I'm going to cut... Do I want to cut the Shard Prism? That seems like it might be greedy. What if I do this? If I do this, I have 5, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 sapphire sources? That seems like plenty. And I have how many diamonds? 7, 11, 13, 17 diamonds. So 17, 15 plus this. That's probably fine. It might be one light on the diamond side. Maybe I'm supposed to cut one of these for another diamond shard. Just to like consistently get that. That's close. Arcane Focus probably makes it fine, so we get to see more cards consistently. Cut a slow shard, get out of here. I'd much rather have a slow shard and be able to play my cards a turn behind than anything. I suppose, like, maybe you could say cut a slow shard for another Crypt Dust, but we only have 10 Necrotic, and I'm boarding two of them out a lot of the time, so I don't think that's something I want to do. Let's take a look at the Diamond, Sapphire, Necrotic here again really quick, and just double check and make sure there's not another random one of we want to play. Yes, yeah, that's another reason I don't really want more than two. Soul Slaver, create a phantom and put into play if you gain life. That doesn't seem particularly good. Any of these, anyone think of any of necrotics in our colors, in our shards, that we may or may not want to play? It's not looking like it. Yeah, I think I'm happy with the main. And then I want to cut something from here for this Charge Colossus. Could just be the Scouring Light because this card's pretty unbeatable for the Mono Blood deck. Could also use getting rid of this Pride's Fall. Yeah, I honestly could see a third Tombseeker being okay too. I'm not sure I have a cut that I want for it. Forgotten Monarch is not bad. Which one's that? Oh, this one? It can be a 3. What sockets would we want to put in it? Yeah, I don't think this is anything we're really interested in. I think if we wanted another necrotic, it would be another Tombseeker, but I'm not sure I have room for that right now. I think I'm going to cut the Scouring. It's between the Scouring Lights and the Pride's Fall. I think the Pride's Fall is more flexible, so I'm going to cut the Scouring Light from the reserves here, make it room for a Charge Colossus. So I could use Darkheart. Maybe. We had a build that had Darkheart in it. Darkheart's not great with Infinite Tricks. It's fine with Reese. Yeah, let's try this configuration. I think those changes make sense. Kind of want to cut the Shard Prism. I'm gonna be conservative and cut the Shard Prism for another Diamond Shard. I think that's conservative. These are like kind of utility when we're flooding out because they make Rutherford Banks work, so it feels less bad when we flood because we have those. Let's do this. No, Mad Robomancer is a dwarf. I mean, they were expensive before I started. I actually bought 4 copies for my wife this morning, and they were like 300 plat a piece. I mean, other people can break cards too. I didn't design the Kaiju Crusader deck. That deck's very good. Arguably the best deck. Ugh. Battle time. This is probably a hard matchup. Lapidary's not going to be very good. Infinite Tricks is fine. Reese is fine. I've got Transmogs, though. Greed is good. We're on the draw. Sapphire Shard, Arcane Focus. How could we ever mulligan? Watch us miss our second shard in 4 looks. Ooh, that's redraws at least, I suppose. Shards! God bless. Alright, well, I'm still gonna focus this turn because we could hit a slow shard. Alright, sweet. So we're gonna get to play a 3 drop on 3, and then hopefully a Infinite Tricks on 4, or a Silver Talon. Adjudicator, maybe Talon first. Yay, no plays is good for us. Clash, that's another card that's just not going to be stellar. We'll figure out if our reserves line up well enough for this matchup. We might have too few cards on our board for this match. This is Mama Yeti, that's going to be terrifying. Yeah, no plays is great for us. We can just like play these sites out and then kind of build up here. I guess if I play this Lapidary out, he couldn't actually keep attacking with that, which is interesting. Maybe I'm supposed to do that. I could also sequence this so I go Silver Talon into High Infinite Trick, shift off onto Silver Talon. Flickering Gobbler, that's pretty good. Alright, so I think I'm playing Lapidary next turn. Lapidary hold Martyr, probably. Yeah, that seems reasonable. And then I can clash away the Monument of the Martyr and some other things next turn. Yeah, seems okay. So, Martyr this turn, Slow Shard Clash the following turn. Are we just dead? 2, 4, 8. We're going to 1. Yep, 4, 8. Go to 1. I think we're just dead next turn, though. Yeah, we're just dead next turn. No, okay, I can Lapidary take 1 and then play Infinite Tricks. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 129, 130, 131, So I can play this. And then, so this puts me down to four cards. I'm not going to get to draw cards with that, but that's fine. So I get to play this. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and hit him with this, take one of his bots away. And then we're dead to any removal, but we can't play around that, so... Except... we'll play this. If he doesn't have removal, we're in an amazing spot, but like chances are he has a burn in his hand, so... Another Crackling Bolt or a Rage Fire or something. Sun Soul Phoenix. Yeah, that's pretty good for us. That attack's super aggressive. Alright, yeah, block. Wow, are we actually gonna pull this out? Play this. Alright, what's the best line here? So, I can infinite tricks and shift onto this as a 4-4 and hit him. Yeah, that seems great. And then banks this back. Yeah, sign me up. Wow. God, these cards are just so powerful. So powerful. And we're going to shift the flight over to this because I want the extra point of life. I guess this makes another chump blocker. Correct. We're never drawing off of this one. Well, I guess he could hit a bulk of... you like double birding? No, I like doing this and getting this online. It's possible I'm supposed to leave flight on this so it can chump something, but I feel like I don't want to chump with this, so this is fine. So he's Gobbler in his hand that we know about. He's only got 3 actions in here, I think. Yeah, so he's got to put 3 more actions in the bin to get the Phoenix back. Sure, just don't care about that. No way he can attack here, right? So, looking for a necrotic to reset this. That's a heck of a necrotic to reset that. Alright, well, we play this. And we play this out and reset that. And then, yeah, wow, I think we're going to win this game. Yeah, famous last words, I suppose. But, yeah, crunch. Just no blocks? That's strange. Okay. Oh, crap, we're gonna get Lasgard's Vengeance. Crap! I could have played around this, too. Oh, he's gonna Vengeance us. Okay, not Punish. Okay, so I should have held Martyr up there. That was completely incorrect. If we got Lasgard's Vengeance, we completely deserved it. But, better lucky than good, as the kids say. So, yep. So Clash of Steel out... Some number of Martyrs out, at least one Lapidary out, probably. Probably don't want to draw too many sites. Probably don't want all these Bring the Justices. Soothing Breeze probably actually isn't very good. I could see one being okay. Let's try this, I think. Lapidary's medium. Lapidary definitely won us the game. Like, Lapidary's a removal spell that then blocks, basically. Probably want Toughness Gem on it. We definitely want the Toughness Gem on the ones we're keeping. I could also put a Major Gem in here. What Major Gems are... So that doesn't do anything. These don't really do anything. I mean, I guess this is... Enfeeblement could be real. Beware Riposte. Yeah, that's true. Makes sight worse. I think I want some sight still. It makes Soothing Breeze worse too, though. Yeah, Toughness Gem's probably ideal on these. Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, I think I'm going to run it like this. I could see cutting a justice and bringing in another verdict, but I think I want removal, especially on the draw. I could see another martyr, too, for martyring my own things, but YOLO. Resun 2, sign me up. Land of Pause Sight on 3, hopefully, when he doesn't ever post up. Justice. Removal spell's a good add. Hey, Toddler. Thunderfield Seer. Okay, so he's just playing like hodgepodge. These are Sapphire Ruby cards I like. Let's play this. Tunnel Reese. Reese is less good in the Sapphire Mirrors because when they're killing him, usually it's with Transmogrifates, but not only can we not banks it back, but it only costs them one. Alright, so we get to get our Land of Pause Sight off next turn, which sounds great. Taking a little bit of damage here, but that's fine. Infinite Tricks here will likely meet either Crackling, Crimson Bolt, or Transmogrifate, but if we meet Transmogrifate, that's a Transmogrifate that's likely not killing the Reese, so pretty happy with that exchange, if that happens. And if the Infinite Tricks lives, like, we're probably just going to run him out of the gates, right? Has another shard? Okay, that's pretty good. So he's got two sights off. And this has Prophecy on it. Okay. Hopefully he hits two Prophesied cards here and has to put one back in his deck somewhere. Upside to Crimson Bolt killing this is that it would allow it to get banked back later. Another shard. Play this out. So we were two turn. T-minus two turns till Reese. Which does actually block his 1/1 on the ground, which is nice. And if this doesn't die, this can shift on to Reese. If he's got a Phoenix here, we'll take a little bit of damage, but then we can bring to justice it. If he has Phoenix plus kill this, alright, yes, so this is dead, I assume. Has Rage Fires in his deck. Okay, that means the next Rage Fire is going to be able to 1-for-1 this Reese, which is scary. Hopefully we hit some of our draws here. Another shard. That's not what we're looking for. So we've got two draws in the bank coming up off the Land of Pause Sight we resolved earlier. Play this. So the worst draw next turn is a non-Crackling Vortex shard. Ideally, we want to hit an action or something that'll allow us to draw cards. But if we hit a non-action or troop, we want it to be Crackling Vortex so we can put Infinite Tricks back into play with this Reese. Not trading here, so taking 3 down to 13, so this will get bigger now. And I guess we'll see if he has Transmog here for Reese or not. If he has Transmog and we draw a non-Vortex shard, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. Here we go. I think we're in trouble if he has Transmog either way here, so let's just go for broke. This also gets it out of Rage Fire range, which is nice. Alright, I'm going to put the last one over here too, I think. This lets it block, and then we're not completely broke. Yeah, let's do that. Let's just leave it a little split. Give me a Warbutt. Although I guess shifting this over means he can't. I guess he already used one Crackling Bolt. Is it more or less likely to die if I give it 7? Alright, Ragefire that. Oh, I guess this, if I would have put another one over here, it would keep him from going Ragefire. Which Ragefire means we could probably lose this game here. Let's draw infinite cards. Alright, sure. Draw 3? Is that 3 draws? That's gross. How many actions are in here? Alright, well, he can bring it back. We can bring this to justice, though. So he might leave this back, so that way I can't attack with the Reese. which isn't completely unreasonable. Wish I would have shifted flight over to here now, especially since his other rage fires are bigger. Yeah, that was probably a mistake, not just putting all of them over here. Well, that's pretty good. So let's play this, and this has, when you play this, draw a card. So I'm gonna go up to 4. Yeah, this is fine. Yeah, I think you're right. I should have, I definitely took the wrong line there. Well, we're getting to a position where we might be able to win this game. Avoiding that with Bring to Justice seems pretty good. We're gonna get another random robot at end step here. We're gonna gain another 6 points of life. It was definitely a mistake not using the tricks to make this a 7-7, though. We'd have gained 2 more points of life now, and he'd be 1 point lower. Random robot says, recoiler. Oh, no! Oh, no, I have to put a card back in my hand. Oh, no, I have to put a card back in my hand. What a drawback. Yeah, you have a line of plus light. That's fine. Yep. So, my mistake coming back to bite us there. We could lose this game. There's a Flickering Gobbler. Yep, that's the start of how we lose. And it draws cards. That's pretty good. Alright, so we play a shard. Play... Line of Plus Sight. Am I holding this? I feel like I'm holding this. Yeah, I'm just going to attack him for 6. So Flickering Gobbler is going to draw him a card. We'll repel it. Yep. Sure. Activate this. Attack for 4, 5. Seems fine. Gosh, could you imagine how much better off we'd be if that Reese had made another bot and it was still alive? Got another attack in. We're in an okay spot right now, but maybe we could be much better off. Alright, so I'm going to play the non-prophesized shard here, I think. Yeah, because that puts me to 5 cards. And I'm going to go ahead and attack with this war bot. And then I'm going to play this Silver Talon Adjudicator out, which keeps us at 5 cards, but lets us draw. So let's draw 2 because he has 6 cards in his hand. And then we still have Transmog up this one when you play this draw card 2. Am I just playing that out? I'm probably going to wait on that. This means I'll have to discard if I play it, but I think I don't mind discarding a shard. Yeah, I really don't mind now. I feel like another Reese will tunnel it. Ragefire is getting scary. You're not wrong. Infinite tricks, sign me up. Then I'm just going to pass, I think, because I want to play tricks and shift off life drain at the same time. We don't have Charge Colossus in our deck right now. That's for blood decks. This deck generated some really interesting games. It's got a nice dynamic to it. A sweet mid-range deck with a clock, basically. Cane Focus. All right, let's start with that. See what we find. We could find like Verdict of the Ancient Kings that we boarded in some copies of to make this Infinite Tricks be protected. All right, the Illusion of Choice, as I like to say. Let's play this shard, draw a card, see what we find. Totem Trap. It's not bad. All right, let's play Tricks. I'm gonna shift Life Drain onto my Talon here. See if that works. He could go kill here. Shift Steadfast off. And again, I'm going to leave Flight on here, I think. Okay, sure. That's fine. And we'll just go ahead and pass the turn here. We got a 2-3 Steadfast Flight. Do you have any draws left in the bank? This is a draw. Possibly more if he draws back up. What's in his hand? He might just be a little bit flooded, too. Ooh, that's pretty good. So this is a necrotic, so it's going to go ahead and revert Infinite Tricks back to a 3-4 with Flight and Life Drain. I'm assuming this Infinite Tricks is about to eat it. I'm actually going to just shift off of this right away, just in case he has another Crimson Bolt and wanted to be greedy here. I'm going to put Steadfast over here, too, and I'm not going to put Flight onto this Lapidary because I don't want it to die to Crimson Bolt. Huh. Actually, wait. I can do that, right? Because then it'll be... Yeah. Yeah, actually, I'm going to put Flight on here because Crimson Bolt only deals 6 to flyers. Instead to Rage Fire either way. So might as well. Probably missed a point of damage or two there with that line that I just took. Forbidden Tombseeker, revert the Infinite Tricks, yes. Play a Shard. I'm going to shift another thing over to here because I don't want him to be able to chump with the Bumblebot and then Crimson Bolt it. It also gains me more life this way. Casual gain 8. Yeah, if we didn't hit something to revert this, I was going to transmog or bring to justice the Bumblebot. I could have played around that. I could have shifted one more. Yep. I forgot his Rage Fires were on 8. I thought they were on 10 or higher. That's unfortunate. Silly me. Another Reese. Okay, so let's play this out. Get this. I think I'm going to shift Life Drain and Flight over to this dork. Just start crunching. Probably tunnel the Reese. Oh, we do have a sweet Reese in the bin. I forgot how sweet this Reese was that was in the bin. I was gonna get back that Nagin Lapidary, but I forgot that this one was sick. And this attack's gain a charge. Ooh, baby, baby. Got one of my guys at random, sure. And I made a few mistakes this game, too. We're just, like, deck is carrying us. My mistakes this game might let him claw back into this. Oh, this guy attacking does keep giving us charges, which is sweet. All right, so I think I'm just gonna tunnel this. His deck is getting small. You're not wrong. I think I'm just gonna bring this to justice. Now I'm just gonna totem trap it after he blocks, actually. Deals damage to blocking troop too. Wow, that's a blowout. I didn't even think about that possibly being one of his last cards. Crap. So now he's going to totem trap this. Yeah. Or totem trap that and then trade? Sure. Oh crap! I was clicking too quickly. I should have martyred this. Am I supposed to martyr my infinite tricks here? How many things am I through? Yeah, I think I'm supposed to martyr my infinite tricks here. To keep my guy alive. That also lets me draw cards with this, which is nice. So now I'm at 3 cards and he's at 4 and I get to draw 2. Yeah, it seems fine. Yeah, just pass. So that was a mistake. Should have martyred the Bumblebot to keep the tricks around. If you don't want your sock on, take it off. If he finds a copy rage fire here, we're gonna be in trouble. Ooh, it's possible I'm supposed to just verdict this because of how good a copy rage fire is here. Like, there aren't that many cards left in his deck. Oh, you know what? I should've just played this out last turn, too, to put lethal on the board. Yeah, that's probably true. Am I supposed to landing pause site? Yeah, because I can verdict riposte. Might as well. I can't verdict that riposte, though. Actually, you know what? No! If I can't have it, nobody gets it. Get out of here. The old verdict my own thing. Straight Edge Savior. You can find it on MTG Card Market. It was my article 2 weeks ago, right after Indy. What you got? I tried really hard to lose this game, but the deck carried me. Yes, it did. Just carried me right on through. All right, I'm going to take a quick break, and I think I might need to change a diaper and get Jake something to drink. So thanks, everyone, for hanging out, and we'll be back with more matches here in just a minute. Waiting to queue, waiting to queue. Hi ho, the cheerio, waiting to queue. So we got about 160 people hanging out here this afternoon. Thank you for choosing to spend part of your Tuesday morning, afternoon, or night, wherever you're at in the world. Here with me, I'm going to battle some Hex this afternoon. We play Hex Constructed, sometimes limited, mostly constructed, every Tuesday and Thursday afternoon here on this channel. If you're enjoying the content, I appreciate if you give me a follow or subscribe below. If you miss any of this stream or any of my other streams, if you're new to the channel, there are literally days worth of Hex content you can find on my YouTube channel, which is linked in the information on the stream. Just below the video, if you're on a desktop or in the information button, click the little I on mobile. You'll see a YouTube button there. Is it really Wednesday morning already? I have no idea how time zone works. I'm from the I'm a USist. I'm from the US. Is Australia? Is it? They're like 12. I guess there's places that are like 12 hours ahead of me, right? So that would put them at 2 a.m. right now. Look at that! Just good deck building. I'm gonna screenshot that one. Just good deck building. Yeah, I'm glad I cut the Shard Prism. I didn't even think about the well crackling vortex hands. Hands so good, too! I think this is a keep. Needs to have first word, obviously, but we can play some cards if we just draw some more diamonds or crackling vortexes. The crackling vortexes are not free. Just realized I had the game noises off since I changed my headphones around. Alright. Yeah, I'm super lucky. That's why we just drew Shard of Purpose. Hi, honey. You know what? I'm probably supposed to have transmogged this. Watch him draw a card now. Yeah, I think I'm supposed to have transmogged this. Sweet. He didn't draw a card. Not punished. Speed. Alright, I changed my mind. I'm going to transmog that instead. Have a different rabbit. Yeah, sign me up. Lapidary Clash. It reverts back to a 2/2 when you take it, if it's like a 7/7. It's annoying. Vampire King, sure. If he attacks, do I trade? I might trade. Nah, that's not true. Not even a little bit true. So, I just transmog this dork? No, this isn't a constant effect. This says, at the start of your turn, check if you have 5. If it does, this gets +5/+5. That's as this reads to me, this is not, because this doesn't just get 5/5, it becomes a 7/7, and then a 12/12, and then a 17/17, and then a 22/22. Do I justice the king? I could just transmog the king and steal this. Maybe I'm supposed to justice the king? I could transmog this, and then likely it doesn't have flying. But I guess transmog is good for, like, speed things later. Alright, yeah, I'm just gonna hit him with this and take his toy away. I think I'm okay taking this. Hit his 2/3 chance to miss. Yeah, I mean, it's funny, I actually got to spoil and write about this card on the main website, and I wrote, that was one of the things I wrote about. I was like, hey, this could be really good with this gem. Take another resource here. Do represent counter magic since we don't need a fourth. If I play tricks, I can't play tricks this turn, but if I did play tricks, it would expose us to, oh, this has flag when it attacks as it gains the Lapidary. Nice. If he has a croc, playing tricks out feels real bad. Although I suppose I could transmog it if he does that. Alrighty, so we're gonna transmog that one. Yeah, let's transmog that one. Random fives are kind of scary, but I think it's better than... Gosh, chirp. Am I playing tricks and shifting off? That leaves the croc behind. I think I'm just gonna focus. Another infinite tricks is pretty good. Alright, now I'm gonna play this. So if he has croc here, he has croc. If he doesn't have croc, he's going to be in a pretty bad spot. Although I guess taking this tricks makes, if he has hero fall, pretty bad for me. So maybe that's a reason not to take it. It's also possible I'm just supposed to have, like, played tricks, shifted life drain, and then, like, cracked him for 3 and gained some life. They always have the croc because they're playing croc. This is probably better than hero fall would be for me. I don't know, it's close. They're both pretty bad. Yeah, I think I was supposed to play tricks and shift that turn. Alright, Reese isn't the worst here. Says crush. Yeah, I think I'm actually just gonna play this. He has another croc. Let's him activate this. Belt's pretty good. Exarch, sure. Hopefully we hit a shard that makes a temporary resource so we can play tricks and shift onto here. Jump. That puts him out of croc range, and it lets him get steadfast and probably life drain and flight, actually. Alrighty. I don't know what I want to do here. Think it's just this. Kinda need a martyr so we can go clash plus martyr here, I think. Don't want to attack in because this is lethal. Now we're just dead to a croc with this line, though, so maybe I'm supposed to clash, but I don't think we're beating a second croc either way, so probably fine to just do what I did here. Alright, sweet. Not getting crocked again, so this is jumping here, and we're taking 6 or 5. He might leave this back. Probably just taking 4 again. I guess he could pay 7 and make it 6. Attack with everything. Alright, well, block here, chomp here, take 4, 5, 6, possibly 7, 8. Oh, this is a bad block, because this puts Balthazar in his crypt, and that means he can get it back with Kaigalichu. So I should have blocked his 1-1 since it was the same amount of power. Yeah, that was a mistake on my part. Okay, not technically punished. Alright, bring to justice. Martyr, some kind of removal. Some kind of removal. Another clash. Well, sure. Yep, yep. We're just dead if he keeps this, which I'm assuming he has, since we know he has Hero Fall. Wow, kept the Croc. Okay, Well then, I guess I'm playing Tombseeker. And there's the Martyr. Okay, so maybe we can stay in this game. Not attacking here because I want him to have three removal spells, or if he has Croc, we're dead either way. But we know he has one removal spell. I don't want him just to be able to go Hero Fall, Hero Fall. Yeah, all right, there's the next Croc. And I guess he's through half his deck, so you know, bully for him. That was one card too deep for us. It's the right play with that, because we could transmog, and then he has a chance not to kill this. Hero Falls this. I guess we showed him that we only have one more Reese in our deck, so we technically gave him information here by making him click through this. Alright, so extra brings, Pride's Fall, this. I don't actually want to cut. Maybe just diversify our threat so we never get this stuck in our hand. Yeah, I think just like, let's diversify threats against the... Yeah, let's just do that. Trim 1-1-1. Bring in this, bring in Dingler. Cut a Martyr. Multiple Martyrs are a little awkward sometimes. A Martyr's probably better. Maybe I just don't want this Pride's Fall on my reserves. Sand's not stellar, but I think it's a keep. Some early interaction to hope we bridge us to the mid to late game. It's possible that Reese is just good enough that I shouldn't have boarded one out. Maybe. Crackling Vortex is less reasonable if we're trying to get... The big part about Empress of Ice... I don't know if you were here when I was putting the deck together initially, Ace. Like, I put it together to start, and then I was like, well, I really only want one Sapphire Threshold if I'm not playing Empress of Ice. So, like, I'm, like, going from, like, needing one Sapphire Threshold to, like, playing a five Sapphire Threshold card. And I get... Yeah, that's true. If the games are going longer, like, it's more relevant. We're more likely to hit it just naturally. Like, we've hit it in a few of these games now, which is nice. And, like, even this game, where, like, this gets diamond here, and then I have Sapphire in my hand, so, like, I'm gonna get to four Sapphire Thresholds at least this game. So, like, maybe that could be fine. Yep, Hex doesn't cost you any money to sign up, and you can play completely for free and earn all of the cards you want. Alright, so this is like 10 to 1 eating a Hero Fall if we play it, so I'm just going to play this Lanopause site out here so I don't just let him use his resources this turn. Him passing the turn, not using his resources, is a big gain for us. Yeah, sure, but if you're not playing more Sapphires to work up to the 5, the rest of its text box isn't relevant at all. I wouldn't mind trying 1 to 2, though, again, just for the sake of diversifying threats. I think I'm gonna martyr this. We'll see what he does. He might not even attack with it if he has another ground pounder he wants to play out. And he can't really attack with this because then I get to take it. Yeah, so I'm just, I don't have any troops in my hand, so I'm just gonna let him attack with this if he wants to. And then I suppose he could have a removal spell for this, but that's fine. It's not that big of a life swing. It's not like his deck has any reach in it. He plays Runeer, that's fine. Well, that's aggressive. So he has Hero Fall here on top of it. Okay. That's unfortunate. I think I'm just taking this hit then and going Clash plus Martyr next turn, or Clash plus Spring probably. Yeah, it's a little rough. That's probably the worst case scenario for us. Yeah, especially now that we hit another Clash, we're definitely just doing that. Ooh, a piece of candy. Hey, Roach! Bring this dork to justice. Got a blood shard back. 50% chance to brick there. Hopefully we hit running shards here and get to just jam this down his throat. That would be great. Okay. That actually doesn't do anything, right? Yeah, I might just wait. Like, if he had troops in his crypt, I'd probably just snap the martyr off, but I think I'm just waiting so I can clash something away too. Yeah, Sapphire that draws a card. Transmogrify, also reasonable. Yeah, do I have any troops in here? I have the Lapidary. I really don't care about that, I don't think. Although, I guess the Lapidary makes it so he has to... And I have this Charge Colossus hanging out here. I guess if he has Inquisition, this is a bad play. But this makes it so he can't attack with the Yakuzin because without removing this, because if he attacks with the Yakuzin, I can just hit him with this. Yeah, the Jeskai aggro deck we played last night is sweet. We're probably going to play it some more on Thursday. Yeah, you have a 5-6. That's fine. He knows I have a martyr. You have a rock cast? This has to be a rock cast, right? Okay, he has another shark to be a hero fall. Hacky with the 6-month resub, half a year. Welcome back. I appreciate the continued support. Okay, well, yep. And that's fine. And a shard. So what am I doing here? Am I just playing Charge Colossus out? I feel like I'm just playing Charge Colossus out. I'd also just Clash. No, I think I want Clash as a fallback. Yeah, let's just do this. Boom goes the dynamite. So what, he has to like kill this plus have Steel Intel? Which Steel Intel could realistically be in his deck. Hero Fall, sure. So again, Hero Fall doesn't actually void the thing it's killing. It just puts it in the crypt, so I can bank that back next turn. I guess he can pressure me now, though. This Clash is about to be amazing. Because his champion power puts some troops in the crypt for Yakuzan. Sure, I'm not sure why he's not attacking with that. That seems strange to me. Alright, well, at any rate, we'll Clash before we do anything. Has to keep the Vampire Princess. Because if he doesn't keep the Vampire Princess, I hit him with the Lapidary and take whatever he keeps. Transmog that? Yeah, transmog it, see what he gets. A 1-3? Sure. Let's play Crackling Vortex. Let's Let's put my charge Colossus back into play, get 8 more charges. Hope you're having a good time, opponent. I know I am. I do not want to take your 1-3 away. You can keep that. Gargolith. Oh, this targets, doesn't it? Gain control of, yeah, it does. That's unfortunate. It's a little unfortunate. Okay, well, that's one of the cards that it could. Yeah, it's really sad it doesn't draw a card when we banks it. Truth. Concedes to charge Colossus Loop. Well, that's exactly what we wanted it to do. Do I want this extra Reese? I almost do. I think Reese is powerful enough that I just want it, especially if we get to Banks it back. Do I want to change anything? I want the Reese. What do I want to cut? I think two of these is fine. I want the Martyrs. I want the Brings. I think I want the Transmogs. Transmog's medium. I guess he showed his Vampire Princess, which is another reason to have Transmog in our deck. Is cutting an Adjudicator reasonable? Especially when he's on the play, where he's going to have less chance to have more cards in his hand. This card's less likely to draw. It's less good. Yeah, this hand's fine. Clash is really good in this matchup. Making sure we hit all of our shard drops is probably pretty good, too. Focus could be anything. Hopefully it's not another shard. Howling Brave on one. This hand's probably... Well, I guess if he's playing Howling Brave on one, he could be going super wide, and then Clash is going to get to punish him. That is not the first draw we wanted. Awesome, Kaijudist. Slow and steady. Okay, that does not play a turn to Speed Rabbit or... Okay, sweet. That's good for us. He's passing. Sign me up. This doesn't play Vampire King next turn either because of his thresholds. Let's go ahead and focus before we do anything here in case we get two shards and one's a slow shard. God bless America. All right, well, at least that draw just really doesn't do anything either, right? I'm glad we boarded that out. Huh. Not worth to focus on one? I don't think so. I don't think there's anything we want to do on two. Miss a shard drop, miss a shard drop, miss a shard drop. Yeah! All right. Now, traditionally speaking, screw beats flood. So if our opponent's screwed, they'll likely beat us if we flood out, but we're in a good spot. Miss, 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 miss rats. Well, we have 4 more shards in our hand, so assuming he doesn't kill us quickly, this Mass Polydingler is going to get to... God, just pass again. We have a Crusader. You got to have a Crusader here, right? Monsoon. Just raw dog the Monsoon. Okay. Bring the Filthy Rat to justice. Yeah, I think we're going to bring the Rat to justice. Technically Rabbit, but, you know, who's keeping track, really? Tunnel Reese on 2, reason to focus on 1. You are completely correct, Ace. We did not get punished, but you are correct. Thank you. Alright, Owl gains life now, which is nice. Look at that! There's our fun of. And this puts us down to 5 cards, right? Yep. Alright, draw 2, gain 5. Casual. Ooh, Ramp Rabbit, right? Yep. All right. Well, if he attacks, we'll trade. I wouldn't be surprised if he attacks here. He's really short on resources. Yep. Trade off my card that gained 5 life and drew 2 cards. Rats! My divination has died in combat. Grab wild in case we take this so we can ramp with it. I think I'm just passing a turn here. I could Banks back this, but if he plays a removal spell on the Forbidden Tomb Seeker, I guess these removal spells are mostly double blood. Yeah, let's just do it since we have charge clauses in hand. Ooh, I found a piece of candy! And then any two of these, if he crocs us next turn, kill the croc. So yeah, let's just pass. Crusader, sure. So this game's over. We'll just mass polydingler him next turn. And then attack with the nerds. I'll look to see what he kept now. Hero Fall Dinglers are the cards in his hand. And Concession. Alright, well, it looks like my youngest is awake from his nap. I'm gonna run upstairs and grab him really quick, and then we will battle some more. Don't go anywhere, everyone. Thanks for hanging out this afternoon while we play some Doing Laps. Good morning, afternoon, night, everyone, wherever you are in the world. Thank you for choosing to spend part of your Tuesday or Wednesday here with us. We're playing some Hex Constructed here this afternoon. We got a sweet little Diamond Sapphire brew that Ace, who was in chat earlier, is probably still lurking around, put together initially, and I've been tuning it a little bit here with him. Seems reasonably powerful. Okay, another Kai'Galichi matchup. I'm gonna go first. Yeah, I'm gonna keep this. It's got Sapphire plus Focus. It's got Transmog. It's got Lapidary. Focus. Hey, my life's like a diamond. If you focus, your life too can be like a diamond. Never didn't have it. If we were going to sub out Lapidary, why would you want to? I mean, this card's not expensive. Like, if you have the infinite tricks and stuff, you should, like, this card's the reason we're playing this deck. To, like, try and maximize this card. So I would not sub out Lapidary. I would play something else, or I would spend the $2 and get Lapidaries. Or 50 cents on Hex Primal. Okay, all blood. Come on, play a Crusader. It won't have Steadfast to reach, so you can't. Okay, play this in case we find two shards and one of them is slow, or they're both slow. I would love a high infinite tricks, thank you very much. I'd like to crunch you with this Lapidary. It's a shame Empress of Ice isn't a necrotic, because I would snap off playing two if it was a necrotic. Hero, Fall, Mandork. Yeah, sure. Okay, this probably is more removal if he kept his hand, so I'm just gonna go ahead and sight here, just to not give him a chance to use his resources. If he doesn't have removal here, then that's a little medium, but I think getting the sight online is worthwhile. Did he mulligan this game? He must have mulliganed this game. I have to go back. Does it say? Doesn't say in chat, so not sure. So this draws a card when we play it, and then we're still at 5, so we'll draw 2 more. Sign me up. Play Arcane Focus. Hey, there's a Reese. Hero Fall. Good. Yep. Head removal, so my read last turn was correct. We'll take a shard, and then we'll play the shard that does not draw a card, since we want to not have to discard hand size. So pass the turn here. A wild back. Ooh, he dumped a freaking nature in here, which isn't a big deal for us because we've got void removal and transform removal. Okay. Howling Brave, Hierophant, Crush, and Sacrifice. That's interesting. Am I just mogging this? Yeah, I feel like I'm mogging this. Alright. That was excellent. So let's go ahead and tricks, tunnel, shard, pass. Oh, I should have done the shard first. We could draw a card that would... Nope, did not change anything, so not punished. He's already burned 2 hero falls. This infinite tricks might just get to ride the wave here. Zenthos Inquisitor. I think this is a great combo on this. But when I put Kai'Galichi together for my wife, I gave it this combo. It's got create a troop, so when this dies, it goes back to his hand, and then he gets to get a troop again. Just keep generating value. So I'm just going to go ahead and martyr this dork. And then I'm going to go ahead and crack him with high infinite tricks here. And then now here's a question. I could just use my champion ability, but I think I'd rather save that for Reese, and I don't want to play out this other infinite tricks, because in the event he has a Crocosaur, I don't want to get them both crocked without holding up Martyr. So next turn, I guess this is bad if he has another Hero Fall, but I think I'd rather play around Croc than Hero Fall, since he already has two Hero Falls in the script. Rotten, Rancor, targeting something. That's unfortunate. Yep, resolves. So I think I'm just going to transmog this. That seems fine. We'll just let his board keep building up. Seriously? Dang it, Bobby. Alright, we drew another Martyr. Sure, I guess we should have just... What are the odds? Never tell me the odds! Alright, anywho. Yeah, get rid of that, I suppose. Play this. It's rigged, yep. Rigged! Cottontail Explorer, sure. Casual 3-3 Cottontail Explorer that bricked on shards. Good little rabbit. Who's a good little crappy rabbit? Yes, you are. Good little crappy rabbit. Exarch of the Egg, sure. Just doesn't do anything. I guess it can attack through my infinite trick, so it's got that going for it. Play a shard out here. Crack him with Matrixie, Poo, and then next turn, when Reese comes in, we will shift all three powers over to Mr. Reese and make a mighty 7-7. I'm going to crush his hopes and dreams with robots. Robots. Yep, no blocks. And even if he kills it, we will Rutherford Banks it back into play. This must have been the free one. This is plus toughness equal to the combined toughness of sure. No, Clash only affects the troops that are in play. Alright, so you should know this is a Reese, basically, at this point. Okay, another Reese. So, Reese is legendary, so we can't even tunnel this one without losing this one that's in play. But that's fine. This one that's in play is about to take our opponent right down to Brown Town. It's casual 14-point life swing here. Just, like, crack you for 7, gain 7... Have Steadfast, make a random robot at end step. Oh yeah, Reese is working overtime. Play your Croc, that's technically big enough to kill my guy. I'll Martyr it. No blocks. Scale of 1 to dead. Where are you at with this Reese? Hopefully he's at the dead side of the scale. Extinction! Womp womp. That's fine. We have a thing here. Put the scary Reese back into play. Yeah, man, you got a Yakuza, whatever. RNG working for us now. Get him, got him, good. Make a martyr. Alright, so what did we do last time? We've cut the two Talons, a Lapidary, and Infinite Tricks. We brought in Bring to Justice, a Dingler, and a Charge Colossus. Is that what we did? Sounds right. Is this the best gem to have on this in this matchup? Yeah, probably. Yeah, I think so. Alright, let's just run it back like this. The bunny died for our sins. Yep. Look, if we get to Reese a Charge Colossus, we can mog him into a Crusader every time. Just like Clash Martyr, keep Clash Clash Lapidary, keep Gis cards so good. Okay, sweet. Let's play that on one. So this only makes a threshold you don't already have when we have a Necrotic, so we'll use that to get our first Sapphire. And this hand didn't actually need any more thresholds because double diamond, single sapphire is the only thresholds we need. Alright, let's earn a focus in case we see a slow shard we want to play. Transmog, sign me up. That'll be good in case he has a ramp rabbit next turn. Do we know he's got shards in his hand? Because Cottontail Explorer picked up two of them. We actually need double sapphire because of Dingle. You are right, Wizard Kids. On the ball. Sounds like my youngest is actually awake now. I went upstairs last time and he wasn't there. You gonna sack the stork? Alright. Survey says. Dang it, Bobby. Dang it, Bobby. At least we can get rid of this with Clash at some point, hopefully. This says champions can only draw one card per turn. So that makes our landing pod sites real bad. Okay, so he has an extinction that we know about. I'm going to write that down so I don't forget. Extinction. Alright, play Mr. Lapidary out. That's actually a hard sell now because I just drew a second one. It's a little bit rough, huh? I'm gonna play Tricks out, because I think he has to kill this. This races this pretty well. I tried so hard, Gletsy Poo! I tried so hard! Does he have more troops is the question. He has a BK, okay. I'm gonna clash next turn, see what he keeps. It's okay. I'll keep this one. This is about a 1-for-1 because we already spent a card on this. This is interesting. He might value this card and get rid of these. Which I'm okay with because we haven't seen... Yeah, okay, so he keeps his big dork. That makes sense. I think we have to wait until we... Drawing Infinite Tricks is actually awkward too now for the same reason that we didn't play Lapidary out. If he hero falls this, we're going to be in a bad spot because we lose a card out of our hand.
We do have Reese coming up too, though, which is nice. He has Extinction in his hand that we know about. So we don't want to extend too much. An Underworld Crusader now too. Huh. Well, now I don't think we can extend too much. Shard. Okay, that's not bad. So I can play Lapidary. Sure. Do I want to martyr this? I'm not sure that I do. I think I'm just passing here. He's pretty likely to want to extinction away this Reese, I think. It's possible I pulled the trigger on Clash too early. Little bunny foo-foo hopping through the forest, picking up the field mice. Does he have a croc is the question. Does he have a croc is the question. How greedy am I? This might be greedy. He hasn't played a hero fall yet. Rotten Rancor, his guy back out. Sure, yeah, for the sick value. Yep. All right, Reese. I'm gonna need you to pick up this game and carry it on your back, good sir. Shard that makes a temporary resource next turn would be great, so we can go infinite tricks and shift life drain and steadfast onto this. And then hopefully Reese can pick this game up and carry it on his back. If we hit running shards so we can double over and then bring Reese back next turn after he kills it, we might be able to pull this out. Especially if we get some killer robots, bro. Alright, well, there's first thing. First request granted. We'll give this steadfast and life drain. And then if we get a killer robot and we get another shard next turn, so we can bring this back into play. Alright. Attack for 14 or 7 here, go to 14. Worker bot, not the stellar Robotron we are looking for. His hand is just loaded with action because he drew 10 cards last turn. Got a Cottontail Explorer, little bunny foo-foo, hopping through the forest. Maybe we can deck him, he's down to 19 cards. Our hero has fallen. We have a croc, we're dead to croc, no, yeah, we're dead to croc exactly because this goes to 13 and he should have a croc, right? Like he hasn't played it yet. Dead to croc. Dead to croc. Are you sure we tunneled Reese, right? Create a random robot instead. Block here, chump here. Seems fine. Alright, we need a shard. So we can put Reese back into play. We need a shard to put Reese into play. Bring to justice. I mean, okay. Yeah, I'm gonna lead on this. We'll revert this because he might block with this to draw cards here. Thinking he still has this giant rabbit. Yeah, sweet. Alright. And we'll bring this dork to justice. Man, we're in this game! Oof. Well, I mean, we're probably not really in this game. Like, he's got 9, 10 cards in his hand. Like, he drew 10 at one point. But if we draw a shard, we get our Super Reese back. All I want for Christmas is a Super Reese. He's probably got Extinctions and Hero Falls and stuff in his hand. But, you know, maybe we're just really lucky and he's really unlucky. That's fine, you know? You gotta get through it eventually. Oh, man, so Super Reese is gonna get to make a robot if we draw a shard? Come on! Daddy needs a shard! Alright, Daddy will settle for a 5-4 with... Alright, so we're dead to removal plus Droop. Man, if these would've come in the other order and gotten the shard to bring the Reese back, and then gotten the Infantrix the following turn... Alright, now we're just dead to removal, because this makes a thing to make this lethal. And if he doesn't have removal, we still have to jump here. Yep, our hero has fallen. Sure. Let's go to the next game. Do I want some Verdicts of the Ancient Kings? I feel like if we stop a well-timed removal spell, we're just going to ranch him. I'm going to try this. Which may or may not be right. Yeah, sounds fine. We got a spell shard here. Gives extra charges. Gets us stored our champ power sooner. Where's the term ranch him originate? I don't know. It's just a thing people say. And I say it. Maybe people don't say it, but I say it. I definitely say it. Forbidden Tomb Seeker. Yeah, let's just get that online ASAP. Why not? Grow my child. Halt in the sideboard for counter, because there aren't a lot of decks that play counter magic right now. There just aren't. Right, so we'll bring this nerd to justice and then crack him for 2. Alright, we'll see if that's better than a Lapidary here. It might be Lapidary! Lapidary seems solidly medium in this particular matchup. Because of all their flying stuff, especially without Empress of the Ice or Josephina to force it through. I like some because I think it makes the game warp in a particular way, but it doesn't seem awesome. It's a good play for us. And a straight brick. Who's a good little cocktail explorer? Yes, you are. Oh, God, it bricked and he missed a shard? That's just like the worst feeling in Hex. Been there. This is why I don't only play one of this card. All right. Focus. Hello, the illusion of choice. We have all of our thresholds. Might as well just gain a bunch of charges here. Play this. Grab a sapphire. Crack for 3. I thought you were saying wrench him. Nope, ranch him. Our ranch, just like ranch dressing. Like a cowboy ranch. Oh, can this one miss too? Come on. Come on, bunny. I believe in you. 2 bunnies can brick in a row, right? Yeah, there you go. 2 rabbits, 1 shard. That sounds like a really dirty internet video. 2 rabbits, 1 shard. Exarch of the Egg. Well, that holds this dork at bay. A stork is going to tick up to a 4-4, though, which is nice. Very nice. Hit me for 1. Yeah. Seriously? So we've had 8 shards in... And Focus saw extra cards, right? That's tough. I guess we kept a 5 shard hand, right? This is my fault. Screw does generally beat Flood. We said that earlier today. Let's see. We can run it off here. Because you're farming them for points, right? If we hit infinite tricks and get to protect our threat with Verdict, like I mentioned earlier, that might be really good. So tricks would be sweet. Any non-shard would be sweet. Please, please. That's all I want for Christmas are cards to play. Cards to play. I guess if this was a Lapidary here, we'd feel better. It'd probably just die, but we'd get to steal his rabbit, possibly. I think I'm trading here and just bouncing this back into play. Yeah, you just can't take this much damage. VK. Inquisitor, sure. Okay. Murder. That's not a shard at least. He's drawn out of his screw, and we're still flooded, which is how screw versus flood goes. You know, they get out of it, and you're still in it. That's, like, the worst-case scenario. It's a removal spell that we can't verdict? It's a removal spell I can't verdict? So now we need to draw Clash or Dingler. Dingler would be great. We've got a Dingler in our deck. Now just feeling super bad about all of my life decisions made up until this point in this game. Even this match, just, like, this could be a... This could be a different thing. I think I want verdicts. I think if we have a healthy mix of shards and non-shards, the verdicts are fine. Okay. Ask and you shall receive, I suppose. Pick your favorite. Get rid of the rest. So probably keeping the 3-1. I don't know. 3-1's not particularly good against. You might keep the 4-power guy just because it's got 4-power. Yeah. It's a faster clock by one turn. Alright, so... Am I martyring this? I feel like I'm taking at least one hit here, which might be wrong. Yeah, I'm just gonna martyr this. Please don't have a play, please don't have a play. Like, the odds of him not having a play are super low there, right? Okay, well, you know. Sure. If we martyred the last turn, we'll martyr this turn, right? That's fantastic. Yep. All right, you keep bricking, we keep hitting. Well, I guess we want him to not have shards. Okay, because he's obviously got... What 5-drops do you have? Extra deal. I guess, oh, that's kind of scary. It's got, All right, so we need another, clash here. Even Dingler's not very good anymore. That'll do, pig, that'll do. Alrighty, yep. Put this one back into play. No, I can't do that yet because if he kills this... Yeah, I need to save this to bring this back, I think. That was one of my bibbity bombs. We had bibbity bombs to draw, and that was one of them. He could kill us and hit us for 8. And then we get to bank this back into play. I don't think he can kill us this turn. We'll see. Okay, yep, dead. Put us down to 3. Ben, take a sip. Okay, so, yep. God bless. All right, we're doing it, fam. We're doing it. We're doing it, fam. All right. This has been a clutch set. Keeps the Exarch of the Egg, sure. Put my Charge Colossus back into play. You attack, I block, I bring it back. Have to martyr this, I think. I'm gonna put a stop during his main two. I think I'm obligated to martyr this. Yeah, I'm gonna martyr this. Otherwise, this gives us minus one, which is a way for him to get rid of this permanently at some point. Maybe I'm supposed to wait a turn or two to see what else I draw, but... Alright, and the fact that I hit a shard here meant I can put this Forbidden Tombseeker back into play. Because this shard means I can bring this Charge Colossus back. And I'm not going to play the shard because I don't want him to know I can bring the Charge Colossus back. Because this might induce a misplay out of him. I mean, the format's pretty wide that I don't think you have room to board narrow cards like Crucible. Like, Crucible's not very good in general in the format. And if it was, I wouldn't be playing a deck like what I'm playing right now. What is he targeting? Rune ear. Okay, yeah, so I'm just going to verdict this. Might as well. Because the rabbit would be a 7-6 to the Monument of the Martyr, so it would live. Well, that was a bad draw, but this was a good draw. So... Steadfast. Oh, that was bad. I should have done Life Drain first. I don't think it matters. He's only got two resources up. This is probably the game, this hit here. Man, maybe I want two Charge Colossus for this matchup. I don't know. You want to draw it. Thud. Thud! It's the sound that Charge Colossus makes when it hits your opponent. Good old Thudderoony. Alright, gets a shot at removal here. He's got Hero Falls in there. Gets a Hero Fall back, okay. Little does he know, we have Crypt Dust in our hand, so we can get a charge and then bring this back. It's not very good against Kaigalichu, because Kaigalichu, they're always going to get something back with their activation. If you could stop Kaigalichu's activation with Crucible, that would be fine. Wintermoon's not a deck that sees play at the top level. And obviously, like the cards that you're playing vary depending on the spot in the ladder that you're playing at, but at the tippy top of the ladder, Wintermoon doesn't see play because it's not particularly good in general. Crackling Torment, right? Okay, yeah, maybe I should technically play that out. Ooh... Ooh, that's a little rough. I'm glad. So this is a 6-7 because of our Monument to the Martyr. So I'm glad we have this shard to bring our thing back. I guess if he has another removal spell next turn, we could die. Hopefully we just hit a removal spell here. Alright, another shard. Meh. That's fine. So we are exactly dead to a... And you know what? It's possible I should have left a... We're dead to another spot removal spell. I should have left one point of power and toughness on the Infinite Tricks to play around him having a Croc. I think that was definitely a mistake on my part. Do you have the Hero Fall or not? Either as dead or as not. This is a nuts match. A lot of good. This third game especially, a lot of back and forth. This card did exactly what I wanted to do, which was go over the top of Kaigalichu. So I'm glad we threw that in the reserves. Yeah, I think I have to block here. So if he has another Croc here, he gets to live another turn. Oh no, because Croc, this still... Yeah, I don't have two troops. Never mind, I'm a big dumb stupid. I know you did well, IB Casual, but that deck's not popular at the top, and there's a reason it's not popular at the top. Alright, Rotten Ranker, something back into play. He gets to draw some cards. Sweet, okay. We have a game still. Sweet. Okay. I'm at 28, and I've got a Charge Colossus loop going, but our opponent's not just dead yet. Draw some cards, sure. Put Charge Colossus back into play. Alright, and dead. I'm gonna go grab my youngest. I'll be right back. Sorry for all the breaks today, but I am a father first. Thank you everyone for hanging out. I'll put the deck list back up, and we're gonna play for another hour or so at least after I get back. Yeah, this new headset is great. People are playing some weird decks on the ladder. Ran into Boris Blastforge deck using... A big part of the reason it works so well is that no one really has sideboards against it. This deck is gas. Yeah, this deck seems sweet. Peace, Immortals. See you on Thursday. Catch you on Discord in between. Thank you. I do not. No idea. Sounds like a question to ask on the forums. Alright, back to where we started. Ruby aggressive nonsense. Yeah, resun 2, infinite tricks, some removal, sounds great. Opponent likely playing a Gobbler Phoenix deck, so that's all they play. Take this stop off their second main phase since it's no longer relevant. We'll play Diamond and Tunnel Reese next turn, probably bring something to Justice the following turn, and then play Running Infinite Trixes and hopefully just beat him into the ground. Blamsmith, sure. Play your 2-2 for 2. So this is, if it's Scrounge 3, it gets +3/+3, and creates a Blam Sack when it dies, and it's got Dreadlings on it. So that's kind of sweet. The first one enables the second one, I suppose. We're definitely just going to bring this to Justice, though. We don't have anything else to do with our resources next turn, and it stops him from creating Dreadlings. So the first Blamsmith enables the second Blamsmith, which is a neat interaction, but let's just get rid of it here. So this has 3 more turns before it untunnels. Alright, going to 19 here. Gets his combat training back to his hand. Would not mind finding a Silver Talon. Clash is medium. Probably wait till he commits one more thing to the board. He also has to answer this or he's just gonna die. Could have double burn here. Transmog, Agent of Mole. And this attacks. Add a sabotage counter to this. Create a booby trap for each sabotage counter on this and put it into here. Okay, so there's booby traps. Speaking of, a booby trap says that this will be put into your hand or crypt. Void it, and it deals 4 damage. That's interesting. This attacks the sabotage counter. Create a booby trap for each event. Put it into it. Yep. Well, this keeps his Thunderfield Seer at bay, which is nice. Am I going to play this? I think I'm going to play this. Yeah, I really want to hit resources so I can Rutherford Banks this back. Yeah, hit a shard. I already have 2 martyrs, which is plenty. Play this. And I'm going to leave this back just in case he has another, in case he has another transmog here. And if he has another transmog, that means Reese is likely to go to work, so... Alright, put some booby traps in your deck. I should have attacked first here, I suppose. And then put booby trap counter... Wow, so this puts 1 in, and then 2, and then 3. That card's sweet. I think this card's seen play before. It might be playable. Maybe we'll work on decks with this at some point. Okay, sure. You're going to combat training this, so I'd have to trade my infinite tricks for it. I'm, like, snapping off this trade here. This is great for me. If he wants to trade Gobbler plus a burn spell for this, I'm pretty happy with that. So he's probably got burn, or charred fireball here, and that's perfectly fine with me. Yeah. So it's great for that. Gobbler's just going to eat me alive otherwise. It should mean both of these are living too, which sounds great. I'm just gonna load his deck up with booby traps and such. This clash is looking real awkward. Hopefully we just run some shards off here so we can get this infinite tricks back in 2 turns. So we'll attack, and his deck, if I understand, this card's gonna go up to 49 cards and get 2 booby traps. Yeah, that's exactly how that works. All right, so he takes 5 and goes to 16. We get a random robot. Survey says Dreadling, which got created during the end step, so it's still alive. Lazgar's Vengeance. Well, let's martyr this. Alright, so Reese is still alive, which is nice. He could have another burn spell to kill Reese here, I suppose. Yep, Crackling Bolt, sure. So, he's gonna combat training, probably the new Bumblebot, and then... Oh, sure. Just not making a new Bumblebot? Good. Making new Bumblebot's good for us. Take a little bit more damage this turn, but it means we get to clash it away next turn. Clash plus Martyr. Hopefully we hit a Shard and then get to bring Infinite Tricks back into play. It's close between Tricks and, Tricks and Reese here. I'm actually not sure which one I want. What do you... Go ahead and comment in chat which of the two you'd put back into play here. Would you bring back Tricks or would you bring back Reese? Reese is probably a faster clock, right? This is a 4-5 though. What do you think, Chet? With this martyr in our hand, what do we do? Reese probably kills him in 3. Infinite Tricks kills him in 4. Yeah, I think the life drain's relevant here too. Yep. I think if Reese was a 2-turn clock versus a 4-turn clock, I'd bring back Reese, but this is only 1 turn longer and it can buffer our life total in the event something goes wrong. Like this. This is something that could go very wrong for us. Okay, well, that went better than expected. Please kill this, please kill this, please kill this. Okay. Well, I guess actually Reese would have been better against that, right? Because Reese would have made a random robot. So that's something to think about, that Reese would have been better against the Zygomunt's game. Because he would have put another body on the table. But I guess he also would have gotten to attack with his Bumblebot in the meantime, so... Now we're just looking for troops. Alright, some card draw I'll do in the meantime. Yeah, that's definitely fair, Coach, is that if he had removal like he did, we'd be at a lower life, though. And we probably would have had to burn this martyr, because he would have hit us with a bot before he's Zygomunt's gamed. If we draw average at this point, I think we're a favorite, but there's definitely sequences out of both of our decks. Mostly like that involve us losing this game. He's got Phoenix and stuff. We know one of his cards is a combat training, right? Yeah, he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Kilning's card. Yeah, just like every random card in his deck. Alright, come on. Not actions into troops into cards. Yeah, sweet. Consistency. Hey! Yeah, alright. Sweet. So... Lapidary? Did I play Lapidary or do I play Tricks? Yeah, I think I just play both. Ooh, that's good. Because now I can play this. And I can shift Life Drain onto the Lapidary. And then if he kills the Lapidary, I can play this and get Life Drain back on the Tricks by reverting it. Yeah, so we should very likely have a life gain troop next turn either way here, which is nice. Not having Martyr up's a little scary, but we also have a flying blocker, so that's less scary. Honestly, if he plays action, including combat training on this to make this a 4-3, I'm probably going to trade with the Lapidary here, just because I have this to reset. Alright, if he has Transmog plus removal here, we're just dead, obviously. Once per turn, the next... That's really good. Wait, that doesn't... Sure. Yeah, that's fine. Circle Preservation. Once per turn, the next time target card or champion would deal damage to this turn, prevent it. Put this card into your hand, it gets plus... Oh, so I should do this and do this. That card's actually going to be very good for us. And we're not activating this ability because we just want to gain a bunch of life. Then I'm going to go ahead and shift this over to here. So whenever we draw a card, this gets bigger. Psychotic anarchist, sure. Don't care about that. So, prevent damage from that. Forbidden Tombseeker will trade with his Psychotic Anarchist. We'll take two. We'll replay this circle. We'll hit him for five and gain five. Now that's a bit awkward, you don't say. Don't want to activate this because, again, I just want his ability in play. Play this out. We're definitely playing this. And am I shifting here? I think I want to leave Martyr up just in case. Although if I shift over here, yeah, I'm just going to focus and shift, I think, because this is a good insurance, I think. Because this way, this will be lethal next turn as a 7-7 with flight. Because it'll have, when you draw a card, put a thing on this twice. This is only bad against Transmogrified. Even then, we're not just dead. Alright, sweet. So, we'll take repels, we'll take totem traps, we'll take some verdicts, probably want at least one Soothing Breeze. Clash of Steel is not stellar. Reese is medium, but fine. Lapidary is a trim. We put the plus toughness gem on the ones we keep. What else do I not want? So 65 cards. Trim at least one Lanupa's site. I'm not playing... you can check the resources by clicking the Hextex button, but I am not. I've got a couple of Cryptusts and a couple of Crackling Vortexes and then 8 duels. What was the cut in this matchup? I trim Martyrs? Yeah, Martyrs just not stellar. And if I'm trimming Martyrs, I can probably afford to just cut the Clashes altogether. Maybe I don't want the Soothing Breeze. Keep Bring to Justice for the Bird. Yeah, that's fair. I guess I've got Martyr Tube in Transmog, but like maybe like that many answers is good. Soothing Breeze probably isn't very good. Yeah, no worries. Never apologize for asking a question. I'm happy to provide an answer. Even if it's just to direct you to the right place to find the answer. It's not a big deal. Yeah, I think I'm going to save like this. It's possible I'm supposed to trim a Reese. Although early Reese is really good. Yeah, you do actually have to kill them. This hand's not amazing, but I think it's got some early interaction that makes it more than good enough. If this hand gives us enough to do to bridge to the mid to late game, which is really where we want to just end up at against our opponent's deck. I think we're the favorite as the game goes along, and that was an excellent pickup. Probably just going to die, but it is a card that he has to answer, which is nice. I'm not sure why Reese fell out of the format. Reese is a powerful card. I like him a lot. He is high variance, but he is a must answer threat, which is nice. Flickering Gobbler plus Burn is the worst case scenario here. Lets him push a lot of damage. Yep. Now he gets to activate that, and we take 5 here and go to 18. Alright, well, we'll play Well of Purpose out, just in case we want a Mog plus Repel. Alright, I think I'm just gonna Repel this, keep my life total high. Not bad. Like Crackling Vortex here. Get the Lapidary into play, so I'll have Transmog up in the event he wants to Flickering Gobbler us next turn. Rats. Hey, Danny. Yeah, something we threw together at the start of the stream based on something that one of the other subs, Holidays, was actually working on. And it seems pretty sweet. We changed a few things, including the champion, but the base idea with Lapidary and Diamond Sapphire was what he was working with. And Lapidary plus Clash is very powerful. I'm gonna Mog this. This might be walking into a Verdict. Or a Riposte, I suppose. Arcane Zephyr. Yep. That gives his guy Flying and Spell Shield till end of turn for reference. That's why he was waiting on that, apparently. Removal. Alright, Yeah, I think we put Lapidary into play and hope for the best here. Defends on the ground, at least. It's very possible I just... Yeah, we're dead. It's very possible I just want Martyr over these Bring to Justices. Because of Gobbler. How many ways do we have to answer Gobbler? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. Yeah, I think I want an 8th way to answer Gobbler. Let's do that. They both answer Phoenix permanently. Go first. It's possible we might want another Transmog on the board for the Gobbler matchups. So we don't have to keep in three Martyrs. Unfortunate we can't focus on one, but we can well a purpose and double focus on two if we want to. I think the odds of this dying are pretty high, so I'm just not going to play it out. Especially if he goes Crackling Bolt, it feels really bad, because then he gets the Bumblebot. Oh, the Illusion of Choice, that's what we say. So probably just play the Lapidary out next turn, since it's got 4 points of toughness. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Let's play Lap. I guess I could also play Forbidden Tombseeker, but Lapidary seems a little bit better. And then next turn, if this lives, I can Seeker and shift over, so Lapidary starts getting bigger and can be a real threat. So I'm assuming this is dying. Oh, he got combat training with draw card on it. That's gross. Huh. I'm gonna call here. Yeah, this is a Crackling Bolt, but I think I'm okay with this eating a Crackling Bolt. Oh yeah, you can see both of them in the background there, can't you? That they're kids are strange, is the best way to put it. Kids are strange. Asgard's Vengeance, my guys. Yep. Good beats. It's unfortunate. Well, at least that happened before we play this Infinite Tricks out. Alright, well, another Tomb Seeker. Go, go, go. Alright, kill your stuff, please. Ugh. Man, that feels bad. Alright, only three actions in there. I think we're gonna trap the bird. Why no totem the bumble? Because I wanted to save the totem for a bigger threat than that. Alright, crackling vortex ain't bad. We have all the thresholds we're gonna need, so... This Infinite Tricks lives, it runs away with the game, like it always does. And if it doesn't live, we're in the shards are good, non-shards are good point of the game, because two shards let us play this, let's activate this. If he does have to kill this, hopefully it takes him two removals. Alright, well we're just gonna take the hit from that. Into a random seven. Well then, when you play a non-resource card, sure, that doesn't have speed anymore, which is nice. I guess we're gonna martyr that. Alright, start buffering. I'm gonna take that to mean he couldn't answer the Infinite Tricks, so that means he needs to draw an answer to it. Another shard's pretty good for us. We're due to hit shards here at some point. We've only had 4 shards and 15 cards, so... I'm just gonna totem trap this. I don't want to take 2 every turn, and I don't want to trade my Infinite Tricks for his Bumblebot plus a burn spell out of his hand. Focus. He could have Riposte here. I think he would have taken the focus if he had Riposte, though, so I'm just gonna jam this. Alright, that is hopefully going to bury him now. We stumbled, he flooded. Screw beats flood most of the time. And again, didn't block last time, not blocking this time. Choose to play around it. We're winning the race here. We're gaining more than he's dealing. Okay, and 2 shards in a row. Like I said, we're due to hit some shards here. We only had... Now we're at 6 shards and 19 cards, so... Which is fine. We don't have another tricks in here, right? Yeah, so if he... Now that we have the 7th shard in our hand, I might take this trade. If he offers it again. Nah, I'm just gonna repel him. Well, how many does he have? 1, 3, 4. He's only at 4 actions. Yeah, so the Phoenix is a little ways off. I'm going to go ahead and just repel this because we're losing the race now. And I'm going to skip. That's fine. Yeah, I'm going to hit him with the Infinite Tricks. I'm just going to cast the Reese. It starts making Bumblebots or Worker Bots as blockers. It draws a card right away. And it... We can shift Infinite Tricks powers over onto it next turn. So, yeah, pass turn. This is pretty good. It's gonna pick us up some, draw some cards. Hopefully. Hey, Leof. Catching us towards the tail end today. Crackling Bolt, the Worker Bot. That's aggressive. Oh, it draws cards. That's okay. So he's killing his own things and it's going back to his hand. Alright, killed the infinite tricks. Drew a bunch of cards. So I get to chant power tricks back, put life drain on this. Probably draw cards first, see what we get. Some of those shards that I was talking about we were due. Put infinite tricks back into play, put life drain over on my Reese. We could still lose this game. I'm gonna hold up Repel. Because he could have Transmog here, he hasn't played one yet, so. Hold all shards. Alright, GG's. Well, what gem is in the Lapidary? For that game, we had plus toughness in it because the opponent was playing Ruby removal. They were starting it with flight, though. So let's go ahead and talk about the deck here a little bit. So again, this was something that Hollowed Ace, one of the subs and longtime viewer, was working on. We worked together on Diamond Sapphire decks for the Radiant Rumble, and Infinite Tricks is just like a super powerful card not a ton of people are playing. So this deck, we're trying to leverage the power of Clash of Steel alongside, you know, powerful spot removal like Martyr and Bring to Justice and Lapidary. Anytime you're able to clash your opponent down to one troop that can't block Lapidary, and then like Lapidary and steal their troop, like they're just so infinitely far ahead. So it's just, we haven't didn't actually play against any wild decks, but this deck is built to slaughter the wild decks. Not only do we have flying troops that they can't block, like they have a hard time racing infinite tricks, we often just have one troop on the table and we're not having Reese out, so that way Croc is not great against us. Lapidary takes their best things. Clash prevents them from beating us by going wide. I really like a lot of what this deck has going on. I feel like we got the resources pretty right here towards the end. Some Crackling Vortexes are definitely worthwhile, especially now that we're playing Rutherford Banks as the champion. I think the two Crypt Dust is right because we do need second diamond, but this is like a nice extra duels 9 and 10 basically with our 10 necrotics. It might be worth trying to test Empress of Ice in here. My only worry on that is that I think I would have to cut Forbidden Tombseeker, which makes the Crypt Dust worse, and it brings our curve up a little bit higher. I like having 12 plays before our third shard, which is nice. The reserves, as far as those go, if I'm going to work on this deck some more, I'm going to need to sit down and jam a bunch of games against the Mono Ruby Yeti deck to see if these Soothing Breezes are needed for that matchup. If those Soothing Breezes aren't needed, I probably get another Totem Trap in here to help the McBombus matchup a little bit. We can't play Purify because we have Lanopa's Sights of our own, but we could play Totem Trap and other things of that nature. I might even want a second Charge Colossus because this card, we drew the one Charge Colossus that we had against Kaigalichu more than once, and it was just excellent every time. It's exactly what we wanted to do. So honestly, if I'm expecting a lot of Kaigalichu in a tournament, I'd probably play a Charge Colossus in the main with a second in the reserves. With that, I've been going for about 4 hours, and I need to feed the kids, take a shower before I go to work this evening. So thank you everyone for hanging out. If you missed any of the stream today, we streamed this deck for the entire stream, so we're going to have a 4-hour archive of this sweet new deck. And kind of, you can kind of see the iterations, like where we started as we grow. If you've ever been interested in like the brewing process and how my mind works, we kind of talked about why we were making changes and why they were good and possibly bad and different things we were testing. Is change course playable? Possibly. The only problem with change course, that's like another thing that's like not affecting the board, and having things like Transmogrifade and Martyr and even Forbidden Tombseeker to a degree that can affect the board before turn 3 is really pretty potent, I think. I'm going to go ahead and find someone to host that I like. If you want more Hex action, I'll be back here on Thursday afternoon. Also, my article will go up on hexccg.com tomorrow afternoon, so you can... Oh, Ali's streaming. Perfect. Ali Eldrazi is his channel. His last name is Andrazi. He's a very good TCG player. He's someone I play a lot of Magic with on the SCG Tour, and he's a very nice individual on top of that, so please show him how awesome Hex is and how awesome our community is, because you all are great, and you welcomed me, and I really appreciate that, and you've been great to me, so do the same for Ali.